from Southern California, broadcasting around the world.
Around the world.
You're listening to the Mic'd Up Podcast. We talk, you listen. But the real question is, are you ready to get mic'd up?
Ladies and gentlemen, folks at home, nope, not yet. Let's go. I wish you could see the confetti, but it's blowing that way. That was a confetti cannon. We're here live. I wish you guys saw that. Okay, we're here live, mic'd up. We're with Colby Bock. We're going to kill a 30 rack, and let's go. Put on the headset, and welcome to Mic'd Up.
Mike, thanks for having me, man.
I'm so bummed about that cannon. The wind, the beach is that way. I don't know if we'll have to do maybe a little slow-mo.
Yeah,
it was too good not to be seen here. But as you folks know, Colby, SC with him, a roommate for a year in Newport Beach.
A little less than a year.
8 months, and we're going to get into that. But as you guys know, we have an hour and a half to finish 30 beers, so let's just get right to it. Let's shotgun the first one.
Yes.
Let's get one out of the way. Let's put the headphones down, right, and let's do a shotgun real quick.
Oh, brand new 30 rack.
Yes, open up the 30 here. Colby's opening up the 30 rack and get us our first two beers. Oh man, what a start to the episode here, folks. We got a little shotgun tool going for you guys. Oh man, so we got an hour 30 here. Let's get going. Where's yours? All right. Let's get one going here. We're cracking up the shotgun tools. A lot of expensive equipment, but we got the full send shotgun tool here, folks. So the counter starts. Oh fuck! We got a squirter here, folks. We have a squirter. Oh my! The equipment's good. Okay.
Oh man, it's
we
a
can't
rough
be
start.
Doing that.
It's a rough
so
start.
Right when we start our first beer, the counter at the top right is going to start for you guys watching on YouTube. So we're starting at like
7:40.
7:40 here. So here we go. The counter starts now. 1, 2, 3. Let's go.
Cheers.
Oh, one down. Oh my gosh. That one hit hard. Oh man, I need a minute here.
Not a good start for Mike here.
Back to back?
Nah.
Hey Mike, a knee chug? A quick knee chug?
Folks, that one did not sit well. Oh man.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a rough start for Mike.
Okay.
All right.
Folks, we're off to a rough start here. Mic'd Up episode number 4. I don't know how much that we're going to get.
Oh, no, we're finished. You can't pussy out after one, Mike.
We have a long episode here.
We do. Was it all pour this up so the viewers can contract progress here.
All right, so we just did a shotgun. I was an idiot and didn't eat lunch or fucking dinner, so it didn't sit well in my stomach right there.
I've done better.
I had to make sure that I wasn't going to throw up anywhere, but we're going to count it. I mean, we're two down. So if you put it down and it comes back up, we got to count that as a beer. I mean, it went down.
It went down, yeah.
So we're at two beers here. He's going to start his third. I mean, all right, we're ready to go here, mic'd up. So, Colby, do you want to kind of get into how we met at SC and you know, what you knew about me and kind of how we connected at SC?
Well, I knew of you through Danny Willett.
Yeah.
Because I went to elementary school
with my cousin,
with
Danny Willett.
His cousin. Mike created a hilarious phrase called Giddy Yard. And that's kind of how I knew who he was when in high school. And then I kind of knew him around SC and whatnot. But it wasn't really until senior year, until we became good homies though.
I know, dude. So the SC times were wild. You had Saul on the previous show. You had, my buddy Joe, and third episode you had, you know, Lucky, and we're not going to get into how you and Lucky are connected because I was told to not speak of that on the show. So we're not going to get into that. If you know, you know. But yeah, I mean, many times at the 901 Bar and Grill, I mean, can we speak on the 901? They heard about that from Saul.
Oh yeah.
And I believe we have a couple of videos that we're going to be going in and out of our times at the 90. There's a video of me and Colby in the 90 that I'm just going to flash either cut
Yeah, we'll put it right here.
It's gonna be right here.
Right here.
So, wow, I can't get over folks.
What a poor start.
The first one I put down, it just did not sit in the stomach. Yeah. So we have some chips. Can one of the guys bring over a bag of chips? I need to get some chips going. Something in my stomach. I mean, so I didn't. Normally I pregame for these shows. Yeah. Oh, there he is, the other roommate Ryan. He's gonna come on the show, folks, later.
Yeah, he'll be back.
He has a story. He'll be back. Yeah. But I didn't. Normally I pregame for the show. Like I'm like 3-4 shots deep. Today I just showed up dry.
Well, yeah, we have a 30,
and it did not sit well. No excuses. Yeah. We're gonna make up for it. Yeah. We have a beer funnel. We have a ton of other stuff.
We got a lot of fun shit planned here.
Yeah. But anyway, so the 901 Bar and Grill, as you know from the first episode, USC has one bar, but that's the best part because
it's the best. It really is the best.
You have any stories you want to tell in the 90?
There's not a whole lot I remember from the 90, but imagine a really cramped bar with how many people do you think it fit? A few hundred at least. Just all sweaty. But everyone that you knew was kind of there. That was sort of the beauty of, you know, only having one bar at SC was everyone you knew was going to be there.
Yeah, I mean, if you see somebody in class, you're like, I'm going to the bar tonight, you know it's the same bar. It's like, I'll see you there. And you know who doesn't go out. You know, we had an issue with Grant Moore not really going out.
Yes.
I would try to drag him out, and he just wouldn't come. Tail end of senior year, but, you know, we got him to come out, so.
Well, you got him to come out because you started doing these call-outs.
That's correct. So senior year for and we're going to flash a little montage up on here. Let's just flash it now.
Yeah, it's some good stuff. Okay. It is.
Enjoy the call out. So people, I was trying to get people to come to the bar, and they wouldn't come. So I said, you know what? I'm just going to throw them up on my Instagram.
And it started out with like
I started out
2-3 people that would be called out, and then a few weeks into it, it was you're calling dozens of people out.
It got to the point where like, so for the folks at home, I've been told for the first 3 episodes to let my guests talk. So I'm really going to try to do that and not interrupt. So it's a work in progress, but, I mean, I just started to do these 901 call outs, like, hey, 3 or 4 people come to the bar tonight and put them up on the story. And it got to the point, it got to the point where it was 5, 10, 15, 20, 30. And it was like, I would go to the bar and people would walk up to me and said, why wasn't I on your story? And
then it was like a rite of passage to be called out.
So let's cue it right now. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Enjoy. So that was a good video,
oh, yeah.
and you saw a lot of different people getting called out, random photos. I'm on my second one here. You're on the third. So
yeah,
the counter up here should say, it should say finished beers. It should say three.
Yeah, we're doing finished beers.
So three.
Three between the two of us are done now.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to have some chips.
Got to get some chips in you, man. That was a big mistake by me. So anyway, we have a Colby knows the photo that I want to put him up. It's can we flash it right now?
Oh, boy.
So as you can see, this photo is of Colby and a woman at a date dash. I know you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, well, we'll leave her name out of it.
No, the woman is not involved. Ryan, were you there with this date?
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay.
Oh, no, yeah, you were definitely there.
So you obviously there, can't see the girl's face. She's having a good time, it looks like, with you.
I hope so.
So she was your date, or she?
Yeah, I can't remember. I think I don't remember if it was a date dash or an invite or something, but... yeah.
Got it. Well, enjoy the photo. I had to start it off with that. I mean, that's what the viewers want to see. They want to see that right there. So after college, you know, we graduated. We weren't really that close. How are these lights doing? I feel like they're working pretty well.
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah, I
sure hope.
Because
the last episode, you could barely see us. So I think these lights should help. I hope. We'll find out when I edit it back.
Yeah.
But we weren't really close in college, and then after me, Ryan, Colby, and our buddy John, who's at a bachelor party this weekend, and those guys are Don. We call him Don, and we'll just leave it at that. But shout out Don. But there was four of us, and we lived together. Let's flash a photo of us at graduation real quick. Like,
yes,
we found each other outside the Coliseum, but then
One of the worst speakers ever.
Oh, but he was talking about Bitcoin.
He was.
What was his name?
What was his name? Can't remember his name, to be quite honest.
Oh, man.
Anyway, he had his own, he was talking about his own, like, university the whole time, but he was a big Bitcoin guy. Shout out Bitcoin. It's made me a lot of money.
I'm a big Ethereum guy myself.
Well, yeah,
and
me too.
The Ethereum is funding a lot of my sins here. So
shout out the Penguins.
Oh, what's the Penguins?
Ooh, the Penguins. I'll show you the Penguins.
Maybe show the camera it?
Yeah, I'll show the camera the Penguins, or I'll send you a picture of them.
Okay.
But they're these NFTs. For those who don't know, it's a non-fungible token. So I'll show Mike, and then we'll flash it on the screen
we're gonna flash this up.
So
you own this.
So yeah,
you own an NFT here.
I own these two here. So these two they're
so
essentially
here's number
of
one, as you see.
Yes.
And then so there's two of these Penguins.
Yeah, so I bought this one for 1.5 ETH.
Okay.
And then I bought this one for 1.62.
Okay. So they're up.
Yeah, they're up. They're here.
Okay.
Mike, how are we doing on the book this week?
My viewers chirping at me how I'm doing on the sports book this week, and
it's not good.
It's always not good.
It's
you know?
Terrible.
I've quit betting every other day. People who know me.
Oh, Mike is the best at quitting gambling because he's done it the most times, because he does it every other day. I don't know if I've ever met a guy who goes on the coldest of streaks possible.
It's ice. Like, it's almost like a gift.
You're Antarctica. You're what, two for your last 30?
And
like,
when people
it's bad.
When I say I was 2 for 20 in summer league, people are like, that's tough to do. It actually happened.
It is, yeah.
Like, I look at the screen, and I'm like, you know what? I like this team. I'm betting on them.
Yes.
And I go 2 for 20. Okay?
Yeah, it's rough. It's very rough.
And then it's like, if I don't want to bet the game, the team I was thinking wins. That's just always how it goes. Like, the Angels tonight, they're probably winning. Can we get an Angel check-in?
Yeah. Ryan, could we get a... Cargyle, could we get a Halo score update here?
Live on the show. Excuse me. A Halo's update? A score check?
Yeah, Cargyle. Yeah,
okay.
All right.
He's going to check here,
yeah,
but yeah.
We're going to get a check
so
here.
So let's just get I got to get some beers down. You know, I didn't want to bring out the Tito's, but may I have some Tito's just to get me going? Because if I get some Tito's, the booze just goes down.
I mean, you're welcome to. It's going to hurt the 30-rack crush.
4-0
Astro.
4-0
Astro.
So, okay. Well, then you know what that's called, folks? I saved money. Oh man, I'm getting chirped.
It does. You know what? I'll house the rest.
See,
of this
we're starting
one.
Slow. Give me a little buzz, and then these things will be like a water.
I mean, speak for yourself. I'm about to finish 3 in 10 minutes.
Okay,
bro.
It's your episode. And if you're down 4,
I'm down three.
Three? So we have a five up here. Five down. Five down.
Don't let him get high.
Five down here, boys. And then we have some funnels to come out, and we have some other stuff
we're
going to bring out. We're like 10 minutes in. We have a long episode here, folks.
We got a lot to talk about.
A lot to talk about here. I mean, we're just getting warmed up. I think the lights are working good.
Yeah. Seem to be.
Well, hold on. So I'm going to let Colby get into explain, you know, where the house that we moved in on the peninsula. Describe the landlord issue, the landlord deal, and then you can talk about the sprinkles cupcakes and how it got off that start.
So, all right, yeah. So
I'm going to make sure the lights are going because I don't want my viewers to be dark. So you can just get...
All right, yeah. I'll just get into it right now. So after we graduate in late May...
For all you guys saying that, I'm going to go throw up again. Just stop, dude. I'm not leaving to throw up. Just chill out.
If he does, I will call him out. Yeah. So we graduate in late May, early June time, and we're trying to figure out a place to live because, you know, we don't want to be, you know, going out to the bars on weekends and then bringing chicks back to our parents' house. That, at least in my house, that wouldn't really fly. I don't want the girls seeing my dad. Jeez. Yeah, it's a burpee day today. Anyway, so it took us a while to find a spot because me and Mike and our other buddy Ryan, who is here live today with us, we all knew that we were going to be here living in Newport. We're working here in Orange County. So we knew that that was going on. And then our other buddy that Mike mentioned earlier, Don Franchise, he was like 50-50 on like staying here, or he might have lived in D.C. with some of his friends from college. So it took a while, but it took us like 6 months. And then we finally were like, all right, we found a spot. We found a spot on 33rd Street on the Balboa Peninsula. And I think it went from like, by the time we found the place and then we toured it and then signed the lease and moved in, it was what, a week?
I mean, it was close.
We moved really fast. And
what I'm saying is never sign a lease with your landlords under you.
Well, we didn't even know that.
And by the way, the lights are looking good.
All right, good.
I checked it.
Right, and he did not throw up.
I don't know. Come on.
I kind of wanted him to.
No,
okay.
I mean, the stomach's empty right now, folks. But
so
stay tuned. We have a big special surprise that Colby does not know about that's going to help me put down these beers. We are going to finish. We're like 14 in. This is my third.
I mean, we're
14 minutes in.
Oh, 14. Yeah,
or
yeah.
So. So this is my third.
Oh, this is my fourth.
We're making great progress.
We are.
But it's going to slow down at the end. So yeah, we had a landlord that lived under, a single guy.
And we did not know.
By the way, can we flash a photo of him? Let's flash a photo. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. There he is.
I hope this is the picture that Ryan took of him at the barber shop.
This is like his. I think he's like a pediatrician or something.
No, he's a. Isn't it like plastic surgery or something?
Something like that. So
he
would always bring over these ladies to the house, right?
I mean, he
had a couple ladies that he just bring over, and we're like, who? It was like a kind of a. That makes sense. A plastic surgery deal?
Yeah. Like, one of five were cute.
They weren't that cute.
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, one of every five.
Yeah.
He kind of got some ass. I'm not going to lie. He was always bringing different girls
back. Well, yeah, because he's the doctor, you know?
Yeah. But anyway, so we move
We don't salute. I mean, it's kind of...
We move into this place.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. We move into this place, and they say, hey, you have both garage spots.
Yeah.
And we're like, all right, that's awesome, because we'll have two spots, and then we'll be able to, like... squeeze one, maybe two cars in like the alleyway, and we thought we're all going to be able to park there. And then when we finally move in, we don't have parking. They're like, oh, you can have one girl
spot.
It turned into zero. It turned into like one alley spot, and it was, oh man. But we're like, what, night one or night two, he comes up, he knocks on our door, and he gives us these sprinkles cupcakes. He's like, hey, like, welcome to the house, blah blah blah. And we're like, oh, cool. Like, it's not too bad. We have a decent landlord.
Could do a selfie for the chicks here. Sorry.
Yeah, it's a little weird that... No, not the landlord. The landlord's son. And the landlord's son was like... How old was Nader? Like 40, 45?
This guy was like a... He was like a 40-year-old, 50-year-old?
Yeah. Just, let's call him mid-40s.
Just still living off his mom's tit.
Oh, yeah. No, his dad's tit.
I don't even know. Is that a metaphor? Sucking on a tit? Like a metaphor, like you're just taking the money.
Yeah, no.
Okay, cool. Because I don't want to. I don't mean it that way.
No, but
clarify on the show.
You fully was.
He was sucking on somebody's tit.
Yeah.
For the funds here, but yeah, I mean.
And he had like six motorcycles.
So right when we move in, This guy sends us Sprinkles cupcakes. Yeah. And he says, if we have a photo, I'll flash it.
We'll flash it.
He says, welcome to the neighborhood, or welcome to the neighborhood. Mike, John, Colby.
Colby and Ryan.
Ryan. And little did this guy know, we were going to be his co-resident from just absolute hell. I mean, we had parties all the time.
Oh, I mean, he wasn't great either.
Oh, he wasn't either, but...
He was ripping his motorcycle at 6 a.m., waking us all up.
I mean, this guy, just never sign a lease with your landlord under you. Ryan, do you have any stories to share about this Nader guy?
Oh, he's unbelievable.
Like, you saw him at the barber shop?
He's unbelievable.
You want to talk real quick in the... Any stories here?
Yeah, if any of the viewers know True Blue Barbershop.
Yeah.
I saw him.
A great spot.
I saw him across
and,
the way.
And did you guys make eye contact or what?
With his 85-year-old mother. We made eye contact.
With the mother with him?
Yes, with him. Sitting right there. Nader was getting a haircut. A mullet.
So the mother,
oh, the mullet. We need to show the mullet.
Was the mother getting a haircut? Because if he was taking the mother... To get a haircut, that's nice. No,
like this guy.
This is a men's barbershop.
This guy's like shitting on us. He's getting a mullet mohawk type deal.
Oh, man.
Like he's got the mullet.
And you have a photo to show.
And remember, he's mid-40s.
You have a photo to show?
I do have a photo to show.
Put that up right now. Look at that.
I do have a photo to show. It's unbelievable.
It really is unbelievable.
And this guy fucking sucks. We hate him. And like, I hope I never see him again.
You might see him at True Blue. If I see him, because I go to the same barbershop as Ryan does also. If I see him there, I have to say something. I'll be like, hey, remember me? And I hope he does. I really do.
That's three down for me.
Ooh, Mike's technically on pace with me, so I got to finish this.
Is that your fourth?
Yeah, this is my fourth. So I'm like half a beer in front of you.
I've slowly caught up here, folks. I think the lights are doing good. It's a much-needed studio light. Anyway, so... This guy already, so we have seven, the beer tracker is seven. What a beautiful rooftop that we're here. Right, Colby? Thank you for hosting. I mean,
oh, of course.
I don't know if you guys can see, but it's beautiful sunset that way.
The sun is sunset at this point.
Yeah. I mean, we're just getting going here, folks. I mean, we're 20 minutes in and we have a lot to talk about. I mean, we're not even close.
No.
We're not even close here. The confetti cannon,
was a good start.
I want to bring another one out, but can you see it? I think we can make it happen. I'm going to shoot it this way, and it'll come back at us.
And it should, yeah.
It should come back. Well, actually, the wind's kind of... Does the wind always blow?
It's always this way.
So I'll shoot it this way, and we'll come back.
So, the viewers at home do not have a full view of what this... But so we're at my townhouse right now, and we have a roof deck. So it's like three stories, and we're on the roof deck right now. But we still play like beer die and beer pong and all that shit up here, and it gets pretty windy up here. So, if the table's like this way, you have to aim like this way and the fucking die like.
Yeah, dude, it just takes some good die skills up here.
It's tough. It's a lot of finesse.
Yeah. So my brother said that if we finish this, that we're blacked out. Do you think so?
100%.
So we're 20 minutes in. We're about to get seven and eight down. Or no? I have three down. You have four.
I have four down. You have three.
So this will be 8-9.
Yes.
That's a third done.
Yeah, but the thing is, you can start strong, but yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we're gonna power through. I mean,
I
Mike did throw up on beer one. Let's not forget.
No, I did. It was a full empty stomach type deal, and I
don't know, like, why didn't you not eat? I guess I didn't eat a whole lot today.
No, because I was working all day.
I didn't have dinner. That was a terrible idea.
I was working all. Like I threw up. I obviously just threw up like the foam.
Yeah, the viewers.
I threw up just the beer.
Yeah, the viewers are going to hear me burp a lot. But
I know. The viewers, if you're, I mean...
I'm going to burp just into the mic.
There is some burping going on, and there's some chewing chips, and there's drinking, so I apologize.
Yeah, the audio is going to be an interesting one on this one.
It's going to be an interesting one. I don't know about the views on this one, but you know what? It's going to be a fun one. It is a fun one.
Like, I don't know. I'm not an ASMR guy. I don't watch those videos, but for those who are...
Yeah, okay. Oh my god, well, dude!
I hope you fuckers like that.
We didn't address that you squirted the beer all over it. It was off to a rough start. Okay, like you and I, there's confetti over here.
Yeah, because I've never used a shotgun tool like that before. So I squirted the first beer, but you threw up the first one.
I'm gonna take a photo for you guys from my phone here, and I'm just gonna show you guys the confetti. There's Ryan, and we're gonna put this up here live as I'm saying it.
Yeah.
Just another view. We have a little script going, and we have two lights.
Mm-hmm.
But look at that beautiful view. I mean, this is beautiful. And now that it's playing behind me, you guys will kind of get to see the vibe out here.
Mm-hmm.
So let's we just showed them it. It's going up here right behind us.
You know what? I wish we did this like before we recorded.
And the confetti, you can see it's all over. It blew all the way into the structure there. But there we go. I mean, I'm gonna stop it now.
Mm-hmm.
But that's pretty cool that they're gonna be able to see what we're seeing. It's like a point. It's like a point of view.
Yeah. But we love a POV.
You know what? For our viewers out there that know what POV stands for. As Uncle Tito would say,
We salute
you. And I was thinking, I would love to get him on the show one day.
I can make that happen.
Okay. Because he's such a legend. Uncle Tito.
I've known Uncle Tito for, like, no, it, minimum, like 15, 16
years. I mean, Uncle
years.
Tito, for you guys don't know, he's a Newport legend. I would consider him like the mayor of Newport Beach.
Yeah, OC.
Unofficial
OC
mayor.
OC Insta News.
So we're going to put up his handle right now. 123. This guy's a legend. This wasn't in the script, but I mean, let's just go with it because we're talking about when we lived together in Newport.
Yeah.
And Uncle Tito fits right in. I mean, yeah. Uncle Tito, you can give the viewers a rundown on the legend because you know him better than me. Just sum it up, a little elevator pitch.
So Uncle Tito is a, like you said, like kind of the mayor. Like he does know a lot of people and people know who he is. And like you're probably going to show like the screenshot of like his Instagram page. He's got a lot of followers, like 40.
I mean, that would be the biggest guess I've ever got on here.
Like 40K followers or
it'd
something
be huge.
Like that. But anyway, so I've known him through my dad because Uncle Tito's dad is a member at the same country club that my dad's a member at. So Uncle Tito used to be a caddy there and he used to caddy for my dad. And just through that, I've known him. He used to babysit me when I was, you know, like 7, 8 years old or whatever.
Uh-huh.
My favorite babysitter. I was always asking my parents for,
I didn't know
for,
that,
for him
that
to
he
do
was
that.
A babysitter.
Yeah.
Anyways, what I would say about him, I mean, the guy went viral for trying to get
a lot of
child molesters out of Newport Beach.
Oh, yeah. I would say that's how it got big.
I salute him for that. Do we want any child molesters in Newport Beach?
No.
Do we salute them?
I would prefer
zero. Do we salute
zero.
Them? We don't salute them.
He would.
Oh my! I mean, can you not burp in the mic? We got people on the treadmill, people at their desk working that are listening to the audio, and we don't want to do that to them.
Hey, I used to be on the treadmill.
Okay, we are going to get into that, folks. We have Connor Fugman wants to hear about your weight loss.
He does want it.
Anyways, Uncle Tito, shout out to you. We salute you. I'd love to have you on in the future, so we can make that happen. Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe
hopefully.
Episode like 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yeah.
After we have a ton more followers and viewers.
Hopefully, yeah.
Anyway, so back to Newport Beach. We lived on 33rd Street down here by the pavilions, and we were already. You're doing that on purpose now.
No, I am. Fully.
Fuck that shit. So like, we were on the verge of getting evicted. I mean, we got. Couple letters, and the guy didn't know that about 75% of the house is in real estate.
Oh yeah.
So like we were all in real estate. We
and
know that.
No,
you,
so I was the only one who wasn't in real estate.
So this is where my firsthand, I learned firsthand evictions.
Yeah,
because We got served one notice warning.
No, in February. We moved in on. We moved in like either the day after or like 2 days after Christmas. So like the 26th or the 27th, and. Mid-February, we're already given not even a warning. He was like, "We're going to evict you."
A month in,
it was like early February.
If we can
find
find these eviction letters, we will throw them up right now.
Oh, I'm sure we have it. It's somewhere in the chat.
Okay.
It's somewhere.
So when you're literally like a month or two in, and it's like you got to go.
It's also what did you expect when you leased?
Why did you lease it
Well, like, we graduated 6 months prior from USC. Like, what the fuck did you expect?
I don't know. I don't know what he expected. So, anyway, we're on the verge of eviction, and we make it to July. We make it that far. February.
Oh, we could have went longer if we really wanted
April,
to.
May, June, July. And we're on the... in July, you'll agree, we're on the brink of actually getting served.
Yes.
Okay.
Absolutely. No, because we did some...
No, we just partied. We're 22,
yeah,
3.
Yeah, no, we partied.
We did nothing wrong.
We just partied. And we partied late. And
so
this fucker.
Let me tell you the 4th of July story. And if you went to SC, and especially you were on the football team, I actually still go down for some NFL players currently as a huge legend. And I'm sure you agree. All I wanted to do out of high school was one. I'm just going to be honest. I graduated SC. I wanted one. I wanted to live in Newport Beach. I wanted to work, live in Newport Beach. Check.
He's done it.
I wanted to work at the Irvine Company. That was my goal.
Done.
That was my goal since like sophomore year of college. I was like, I know that I love real estate. I want to work for the Irvine Company. Do you know how hard it is to get a job at the Irvine Company?
It's not easy. It's really not.
It is not easy at all.
No.
And for me to just have that dream, I need a lot of dominoes to fall into effect there. Literally, I just, number one company. I can't complain.
They're big.
And I literally would have their job postings on notifications. So right when they came out, I get that email. Mm-hmm. Right when the first job, no matter what office, multifamily, retail, it didn't matter. I wanted to work there. I love apartments, but I always wanted to work there. I just remember coming home from the bar I graduated in May of 2018.
Yeah.
And I come home from the bar, obviously live with my parents at the time. And this is June, July, I went to Europe. And that's a full different episode. I mean, Mykonos, Greece, shout out Barcelona, Dublin. You've been to
Amsterdam.
Amsterdam, obviously. I mean, it's a great spot. And
Mike was the unfortunate victim of some credit card fraud on that trip.
Somebody took my card in Amsterdam. And we don't need to get into that. It got literally, no. I left it on the in the fucking canal. And I never saw it again.
Yeah.
So anyway, I get back from the trip, and then August goes by, September. I'm applying left and right.
Mm-hmm.
But my focus is Irvine Company.
Oh, yeah. Always was.
I'm waiting for these job postings. And then I think October comes around, I get a job. A job comes up for the apartment group. And I get the alert at like 2 a.m. I just got home from the bars. I'm literally, my resume is ready to go. I am pressing... I filled out that application.
I did not know this.
Literally 10 minutes from when it was posted. Sorry, an hour after 2 a.m. They posted it like at midnight, I think. Probably midnight.
Who's posting a job offer at midnight?
No, it probably hits midnight. It's probably
automatic. It's
automatic. Yeah, and I was like, you know what? I have to send this in right now, because if they see that I apply within an hour, they know you have the notifications. Probably they know you want to work there that bad.
And they probably think like, oh, he's not out partying.
No, he's just sitting there studying.
Little did they
so
know.
I'm gonna wrap this up, but I mean, this is just one of the goals that I hit. And every time that I tell people, like, they're like, how did you get that job? Who did you know? Who made the call for you? Who got you in? Who got you that interview?
Oh, yeah, because real quick, for those who don't know about Irvine Company or whatnot, it is a who do you know to work there.
Number one private real estate company in the United States.
Oh, yeah.
Private real estate company in the United States.
Like, they're big time.
Number one in the United States, yeah.
So, you were kind of saying earlier that, three of the four, so you worked in real estate, Ryan and Don all worked in real estate. Yeah. I was the only one who didn't, but I minored in real estate development. So, I had, like, at least a background in it.
Yeah.
And because I grew up in Newport, and which is, you know, obviously adjacent to Irvine. Irvine would get brought up a lot, especially in some like my city planning classes.
Yeah, I mean, so
they would talk about Irvine, but then I was always the one that they would ask about like how it actually played out in real life.
And yeah.
Sometimes like, oh, like how was it around like Woodbridge? It's like, I don't go fucking around in Woodbridge.
So anyway,
ever,
I'm just gonna wrap. I appreciate you giving the background there, but we went on a little bit of a tangent, 5 minutes, but you know what? For me, like, obviously I want to hear Colby talk about, like, that was one of my goals, and to check that box was huge.
Oh yeah.
And it's like, just for all the viewers out there, I know we're drinking and we're gonna be doing some beer funnels and some other shit, but if you put your mind to something, and I'm looking right at the camera, and you really think about it every day and you visualize it, it will happen. But you do need a little bit of luck, right? You need the right person to see your resume. And it turns out the person that got my resume on their desk went to SC. And that's it. I mean, that's the bit of luck.
That's SC Network.
And that's how it is. So cheers. This is going to be my fourth.
You're finishing your third.
No, this is four.
Oh, it is.
Four. This is four. We'll check. The counter won't lie.
The counter won't lie.
We're going to play it back. What's that for you?
Oh, no, no. This is number five, I think. I don't know. I think I've done 4 and 30 minutes. Which, as fucked up as it sounds, we're behind pace.
We are, but...
I'm ahead of you,
I'm
behind pace.
I'm not going to rush pace. If we can't get there, we can't get there. I mean...
You know what? We're going to give it a fucking honest effort. I can promise you that.
Because I was saying, like, look, you can't just booze all episodes.
You know what we need to do?
I wanted some content.
What we need to do is, because we're going out later tonight.
Hold on.
No, but I want to say this. Okay. Later tonight, and I want to put it here right now.
After.
I want to do a little video of us at the bar. Whether it's us together or selfie video or whatever. It's tonight. When we're out at the bars, it's going to be interesting.
So do we flash that montage right now?
I think so.
All right.
I think we just give the viewers a little bit of a preview.
What do you think you're going to be up to tonight?
Ooh, I don't know.
It's kind of cool because we're trying to guess what we're going to be up to, but we don't know what's going to be behind us. Are we live or no?
I don't know. I've never used a GoPro
in
my life.
Pointing at us? Zach? Ready for this? Ready for this right here? Colby Bock is a legendary episode. There's no breeze here.
What an amazing episode.
I believe the fucking wind doesn't blow. We'll see you guys next week.
Episode number 5. We'll see you guys later.
Good thing we're getting it. You're live.
Oh
man. You guys might have thought that we were done. No sir.
No sir.
No ma'am. We're getting ready to go. Wild goose. See you guys later, checking in live.
Drinks behind me, that's a fucking issue.
Excuse me? Can you film the video real quick?
Of course.
It's for a vlog.
It's interesting. I feel like it depends on, because I imagine we're going to Goose.
We're going to Wild Goose. Shout out Wild Goose.
Shout out Wild Goose. I was there last night, and I'm going to be there again tonight. It's an interesting spot. It depends. It really depends on the crowd there, because I was there, the last weekend or the weekend before. But it gets so packed in there, and everyone just bumping up against each other, and everyone's in like a pissed off mood and shit. So like, I really didn't enjoy myself there, but I know it's a great venue. But we'll see where we go. We might not even go to Goose. We might go to Blue Beat.
It's
a great spot. We'll probably go to Goose though. Yo, Kai, hot some of that water.
So yeah, so I never got into.
So a little status. Like, how are you feeling right now, booze wise? How are you feeling?
Not good.
Not good.
Not good at all. This is not what I expected.
Okay.
I'm feeling the ocean breeze.
It is a little chilly up here.
No, but it's a lot of beer.
That's not what I'm worried about. I am a little chilly up here. It's been a hot one this week, honestly. Like, my office is out in Irvine. It's been hot. It's been like high 80s,
Colby,
low 90s.
I apologize.
I'm a little cold.
I said that I wouldn't cut anybody off, but we have a lot to talk about.
We do.
I want to get back on topic.
All right. Us back.
We're back to the event. We took a big tangent here, folks, and we're not even that hammered yet. So, Irvine Company checked the box, and now I'm doing great. I couldn't be happier where I am currently, and we don't need to mention the name, but it's like, everything works out for the best, and you just have to trust in yourself and work hard and let the dominoes fall where they may.
Yeah.
Right. So next up, so back to bring you back to July. Okay. I mean, we were on the verge of eviction, and what do I do? What does your roommate do? He throws arguably one of the biggest 4th of July parties in all of Newport ever on the peninsula.
It's big.
And
it is big.
Huge. I will flash some photos. We're not going to pause it, but we're going to put up no sound now. We're going to put up some photos here.
Because I have
and
a screen
it was
recording.
So packed.
Because you put
and
on
all
your Insta
story. All my roommates left, and I was like, you know what?
No, Don was there, but Ryan and I. So my parents live in Laguna, and we went to the beach down there. But you hosted 100? At least?
I mean, I can't say anything regarding we have to be PG here because we don't want to roll our own football team. We don't want it to
be. We won't say who was there.
No. We won't say what they were doing. But
nothing like that.
There was some.
Lots of heads.
There was a lot of SC players there, and they were having a great time. And when I'm talking SC football players, we're talking like 20 plus.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, and obviously, dude, they were drinking White Claws. They weren't doing anything crazy. Like, I'm just being honest. Like, we're not hiding it.
This was the early day of Claw.
Yeah, I mean, the Claws were good.
This is right when
Claw
came
out, actually.
All I remember
is I just met this guy. He's literally just turned 21. Again, not going to say any names because why would I want to get my – why would it be like 15 players are ineligible for the home opener because the Mic'd Up podcast. We aren't doing that. But I give a football player
– they're all graduating.
They're all graduating.
But we're
– and actually some are now seniors. I'm not going to lie.
Oh, boy.
A couple are seniors here. And I've seen them at Wild Goose. And again, we love our football team.
All I remember is
I give a. You've seen that we've been flashing stuff behind us, so they know how crazy it was. I give a player who I just met, and some of them are at other colleges. They transferred. I'm like, here's my card. Go to the grocery store right up the road, and don't spend more than $200 on White Claws. Bring me the receipt, please. Guy comes back. He's like, thank you, sir. Very respectful because he's like a sophomore.
Uh-huh.
Junior, just turned 21, just a younger player that I just met, very respectful, and he's like, "Thank you so much, sir. I got called sir. That's fuck. I hope I didn't get called sir. He's like, "Thank you so much for buying the beer," and I look at this fucking receipt. It's got $199, like 82. Like,
ooh,
these guys,
right on.
They
it.
Just pushed it to the limit. And it was a great party.
You did say 200. You did say 200.
And it got
though.
To the point where I had to – the party got so out of hand that my friends were showing up, and I lost control of the party. We've all been in a frat. We lost control.
Yeah.
And I think I had to call cops on myself. I think I did.
Yeah.
I it got that bad where I had I had to call the sheriff to shut it down. And they walked up to me and they said, sir, if we ever see you again, if this party starts up again, we're taking you in. So what did I do? Ran down the boardwalk. Ran. Anyways, up to the next topic here. So people want us to discuss this incident really bad. And I think it's a pretty funny incident. It's kind of an inside joke.
Which one is this?
It's the LaCroix incident.
Oh boy.
Ryan, I can't see you, but we're about to talk about the LaCroix incident. Do you want to be up here for that?
Huh?
Do you want to be up here for that?
I'll come up there.
Okay. Because
I'll let you guys take over this one. Because
I hope that you don't have you don't have anything that you could say back at me, do you?
Not really. I mean, it happened. Like,
okay.
It is what it is.
Okay. Well, you don't have anything. Okay.
Mike, you take the lead.
Okay. Make sure the light.
Can you guys put those down, though, first?
Okay.
Put those beers down. Okay. Like, come on. I'm just helping you guys. Like, you guys want to put down that whole 30, huh?
I think that was 5 for me.
Whatever it is, I want to have.
Anyway, so we have the LaCroix incident. I need a chip. So, Colby lives in the front room, and we go to the bars, and he brings back a lovely woman. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I just need to preface this. He has nothing on me. I don't think he does, but, you know, this is just funny roommate stories. I want to do a little preface here. I salute women of all body types.
Okay.
I actually love women. I love all body types. You know, you do you, right?
Okay.
But I prefer me personally, skinnier women.
Okay.
Me personally.
Yeah.
But I love all women of all body types. Mm-hmm. Okay. You may have come home with a larger woman, which some people like that type of thing.
It's unfortunately been known to happen.
Okay. So,
because you know what? I used to be a bigger dog. I used to be a 50-pound heavier dog.
He's a skinnier dog these days.
I am.
What you guys don't know is we're going to flash some photos here. We have some photos of maybe bigger Bock.
Oh, yeah. Like,
Let's flash a couple.
Like, 18 months ago, I was 215, 220
And what are you
pounds.
Now?
Like 170,
oh my gosh.
173.
Folks,
right
he cut
skinnier dog.
Yeah.
So you cut 50 pounds.
Well, I got down to 162, and I was way too skinny.
So you cut 60 pounds.
I cut 60 from my peak.
Oh
yeah.
My God. Okay. Don't.
But he was too skinny.
Oh
a dog.
No. I need to go on this because I know our
Mike,
yeah.
Can I come right
our boy Connor Fugue. Our boy Connor Fugeman. This is for you. He was asking for the diet secret formula.
But we have that in the show, but should we just hold on?
We're on it right now, so I feel like we need to go out of order.
But
a little bit.
He's diverting the question of the LaCroix incident.
We'll get back to the LaCroix incident. I'm not trying to get away from this because
this is sometimes you write a script and you plan it out, but you know what? Let's hear it.
Yeah. So
tell the viewers, how did you lose 60 pounds?
You track your calories and you eat less than your maintenance, and you just do that for a long fucking time.
So
weight. It's really not hard. Like, you don't have to work out to lose weight. Like, you can and you should, but you don't need to.
So funny that we just sat here with no beer in our cup for like 2 minutes.
Oh, yeah. That's a...
The top row, folks, is almost done, meaning that's 15. And we're 40 minutes
fuck
in.
Me.
We're 40 minutes in. We're not on track, but you know what? Hopefully we just get absolutely hammered in the next 10 minutes and we can just house them.
Well, dude, 40 minutes. If we finish 15, that's right on. We have, you know what? We have 5 minutes to finish the top row. How many more do we have left?
Top row is two.
Two? Oh. 15,
so
oh, dude, we can.
Fuck,
oh, boy.
Fuck out of here. 15.
Dude, so. No, we just got to finish two more, and we're at 15. So that means
shout
this
out
is
my,
not,
shout
so,
out to my dad, brother, and Colby who all sell boxes every day.
DTBM.
Shout out Dan the Box Man. Give him a little shout out. I gotta show the
you
viewers
know
here.
we're gonna shout out Dan the Box Man.
Show the viewers here.
Dan the Box Man is Mike's dad. He is a phenomenal man, a grill master. A Halo's truther.
Folks, top row is almost done. We're throwing it off.
These chips are fucking dead.
Yeah, kettle chips are some of the best.
You know what? The one thing in mind that I think about this episode is like Dave Portnoy's fucking pizza reviews. We just got people coming in and out. Like we just got Ryan coming in and out, and we might do it. We might actually do this.
So I live with Ryan for.
Ryan, he's trying to divert
most
from
of post-grad
he's
line.
Trying to divert from. The
no,
LaCroix.
I'm not.
And we're coming back to it right now.
Put that on me. I'm
and
not trying to
if you guys
over.
Are fucking shut the
shut your fucking mouth.
Hey, put these down. Hey, put these down.
Okay. Okay. So this.
Oh no! You know what we need? We need a knee chug.
A Mike
yes.
Hand
we need
knee chug.
A classic yeah,
the
MF
boys, the
knee
boys
chug.
Will love it.
But they can't. Oh my God! So that's yours. So, you know what, guys?
Knee chug
fuck
right
you
now. No, knee chug right now.
So, fuck you guys for giving me shit that I threw up the first beer. I'm going to make up for it right now.
Knee chug.
And by the way, this guy is not... He wants to get out of the fucking LaCroix incident. This guy is unbelievable.
No, I fucking don't, Mike. I just want a knee chug.
Well, let's knee on the chair because we got the lights on us.
Hey, should I join?
No, you cannot.
No. If you get another beer...
Do you have one downstairs? How about knee on the chair?
Knee on the chair, all right.
Because the lights will go. One, two, three.
There he is!
Pretty good. Give me a chip.
Give Mike a trash can to throw up into.
This is really good beer right here. Almanac, Hazy IPA.
All right, folks.
You want to shout out your beer?
It's really good.
Speaking
talk
of the
mic.
We got an Almanac Hazy IPA right here, 8%.
Where did you buy it from?
High Times.
High
Times, Costa Mesa, California, 17th Street, great beer. Like some of the best beer out there.
Not only the best beer, the best booze.
Yeah. Like I mean High okay. Times is probably the best liquor store in
folks,
this country.
Folks, this is
best I've ever been to.
I will cut you guys off because we've been, right, no, we have
get
been,
back to LaCroix Story. Literally, I don't care. LaCroix Story, take it away. Take it away. I don't give a fuck.
The lights are good.
Yeah, they are good. Mike, start us off, dude.
Okay. Take the LaCroix Story.
So we're sitting here. So I feel like we've been like, this is kind of like. Anyway.
Just tell the story.
So, and Ryan's here with me. He can chime in because you were both there. And Ryan, when you talk, just talk in his mic, okay? Colby, where's our, that's mine over here?
No, that's.
That'll be 15. Yeah. So
you guys are down half?
No, we're on pace,
you
45.
Guys have put half we're on of pace. Them
down. We're on pace, actually. Colby, we're on pace.
Oh, we man. Are on
we're,
pace.
We are on pace.
We're shockingly on pace.
No, we're at 45 minutes, right?
We are
at yeah.
We started at 40.
7:40, yeah. We're
yeah.
on pace here.
So and you know what? We're like 2 minutes behind if we
it's all good.
We ordered some pizza. There's gonna be some extra for you,
you pizza?
Man. Yeah, we did.
Okay. Maybe on the show we can grease one? Okay.
Oh, do we grease off? Grease off?
Okay. You know what, guys? This is getting...
All right, LaCroix Story. I'm not trying to get out of this.
So all I remember is this. I don't... Ryan, did we go out that night or no?
No, that was like a... It was a midday morning type deal.
When the girl came.
No, it was at night.
No. When did she...
I don't know when
okay,
she
okay.
came.
Thank you. So we all went out that night. And
maybe she came the night before. Hold
on.
It was night before.
Hold on.
Night before.
Now I remember. Thank you, Ryan. So we all go out, right? And I don't really do one-night stands myself. I don't do it often. But I would think when you...
Coward.
Okay. I don't really do one-night stands. But when you bring back a girl, right, you'd think, you know, you go to the bar, you meet a beautiful woman. I'm gonna give you credit, beautiful woman. Just that's like a default statement, beautiful woman.
Yes.
Okay. And you meet her at the bar, you come back, you go to your room, you bring her home, you do whatever you do in there. And you'd think that maybe 9, 10, 11 a.m. noon. Maybe she'd leave, right? Stop.
You would think.
Stop. Okay. So now Ryan is a legend. I'm glad that we brought Ryan in because it jogged my memory. And we're all sitting on the couch, me, you, John, right? And it's like, what, 2 in the afternoon? Right?
About.
3?
Yeah, about.
2 or 3? 2, 3?
I would say 2 o'clock about.
So we have not, we're like, we're all thinking like, is there a girl in there still? We're like talking to each other. You gotta be quiet.
I'm not saying shit.
You gotta be the fuck.
I'm not saying shit, Mike.
Because
I'm letting
is,
you tell the story.
Because there's only this is a crazy story.
You're the one bringing me into this.
Okay, cool. So
I'm sitting back.
I believe it was Ryan. Would you say about 2 or 3 p.m.?
I'd agree.
Okay. So 3 p.m. on a Saturday. He's still in there with this chick, and I'm like, "What are you doing?" We're like, "What is he doing?" He walks out of the room and he's like, first time we've seen him, we've been up all morning, and he's like, what's up, guys? I'm just out here because I just spilt my LaCroix. It was on my nightstand and it just fell over. And we're like, dude, how do you spill it? That's what you say?
I spilt a LaCroix.
So you just come out there and say that.
Yeah,
it's 3 in the afternoon.
He takes handfuls.
I needed some paper towels to clean up the spilt LaCroix.
Paper towels.
Yeah, he came out. He just got some paper towels. He needed the paper towels. Okay. Mm-hmm. And he said that he spilt a LaCroix in there. He's like, I got to get some towels.
I did.
Because you spilt it.
Yes.
Okay. So.
I don't know where it came
from. I don't know what you needed. So you needed the towels to dab the carpet?
Yep.
Okay. So I'm not really putting you on blast because you were. Having a good time with a beautiful woman, but I thought it was hilarious that like he just couldn't come out. And you know, bro code. It's like, hey, I'm with this girl. Like, you know, we're on, you know, round whatever. Like, you know what I mean? Just be honest. But he's like, you know what? I just spilled LaCroix, guys. I gotta go clean it up. So now that I put you on blast, and it's from love. Like, you know, did she leave? I think she left later. 5 o'clock.
Not that late.
4.
I don't think it was that late.
4. She left at like 4.
So the LaCroix spilt. let's call it 2:30.
Okay.
We're saying 2:30.
Can we flash a LaCroix behind us? 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Above Ryan's head.
So I'm
gonna give you two minutes. We have a long script.
Yeah. So we're.
Thank you, Ryan. Ryan, do you have anything to add to that story?
No, I don't.
Was it accurate?
We're doing some.
Accurate. Anything else to say, or
nope.
That's it? Stay here for his response.
Okay. Right.
So,
okay.
So I am with this beautiful woman, and we're doing some quote unquote. I'm using Mike's words. Okay?
Yeah, beautiful woman.
Yeah, beautiful.
All women are beautiful, folks.
So,
I'm like Trump.
So all beautiful. We're doing some rather adult things. If you can figure out what that is.
So just say that then. Just say that to the boys.
Well, the whole issue was we were doing some adult things, and
how many times?
A lot. And I accidentally kicked a LaCroix off. So like my bed is like, is like the fucking like headrest.
I don't know.
And then the mattress, and then so I had a
you
LaCroix.
You kicked a LaCroix off of the.
I kicked a LaCroix off like
the
foot
rougher
of my
stuff. That's some rougher action.
So I kicked it off, and I was just like. Damn, I need to clean this up. So okay. That's why I went out and I grabbed paper towels and I was like, boys, I spilled a LaCroix.
Okay.
So I grabbed some paper towels and I cleaned up the LaCroix.
To this day, I still don't believe him. Do you believe him?
No. That is what happened. That's exactly what happened.
I had two LaCroix here, folks.
There is no way.
There is no way.
What else would have happened? I was doing some adult things.
So you're hooking up with a girl.
And I kicked a LaCroix over.
You might need a paper towel.
So,
right?
So that's okay. What I did. I went in the kitchen, I grabbed paper towels, and I cleaned it up.
Okay, folks, put in the comments.
Like, what the fuck else do you think I did? Like,
hey, Mike, what do we think?
No, Mike, what do you think I did? Like, what else would be different about
that
story?
What do we think here?
Yeah, what do we?
What do you think? I was just like, oh, let me pour this fucking LaCroix on my
folks,
carpet.
Folks, he still
no.
doesn't get it. He still doesn't get it, folks. That's why it's so.
So fucking tell me, man.
We're on to the next. Good.
Go.
Dude, no. You got. We're done.
No.
We're done with the story.
No, sir. No, you don't think I'm telling the truth, but that's what happened.
Okay, I believe you.
No, you don't.
I believe you.
No, oh,
cheers.
No, you fucking don't.
There you go. We got to kill this right now.
There's 15 left, boys.
I know. Come up here. Come up here. Come up here. We have about 40 left.
For the viewers at home, this is my other roommate,
Tim.
Can you
introduce yourself, first name, and oh, he's go Trojans, right?
Go Trojans.
Do you have anything to say?
Into the mic, Tim.
Tim Lindell.
Yeah, so Tim was in the same fraternity.
Like, this is like a fucking Dave Portnoy pizza review.
So
we just got people coming up every minute. I love it.
So thankfully, Sigma Nu was
the same glass.
Oh yeah.
Oh man, see,
these are my glasses,
so,
baby.
So Tim,
I didn't give this guy this glass, Tim.
We're in the same non-hazing fraternity.
We gotta.
Oh yeah, absolutely non-hazing.
So
fraternity.
We gotta finish our
but
drink.
Tim was actually the boy.
All right.
Tim's 2 years older than me.
So this is for 15.
And
15 right here.
Yeah.
Boom! Killed it.
All right, so we are
halfway.
33.
Somebody, if you edit this, just put applause up. We're halfway.
So we're like. We're 4 minutes behind schedule right now. I've downed 8. You've downed 7.
Okay. Tim, you can hang out if you want. I mean, we have a lot of. Okay. Do you have anything to say back at me, or you got nothing, right?
No, I don't deny the story.
No, but can we move on to the next topic?
Absolutely. Yeah.
What is it?
I can't fucking. Oh my God. So we're so this is.
You know what? This is a tit for a tat.
No,
I came at you.
Thing.
Come at me then. It's fair.
All right. So
mono y mono.
So we still need to finish the whole story of why we left. Why we did not continue leaving. Living on the.
No, we're not done. We're not there yet. We're not there yet.
Well, no. This is after. This is New
Year's.
Tim
is gonna hang out, right?
Tim's gonna hang out.
All right, cool. Tim.
So this story that I'm about to tell is my quote unquote counter. My counterpoint to Mike.
You have 1 or 2 minutes to sum it up.
This is after we, at this point, we no longer live on the peninsula together. Mike is, I forget exact. I don't know if you're home or if you're in LA at this point, because you've kind of gone back and forth for the last
I'm everywhere.
Years. But
got,
I'm living
you,
in...
You got 1 minute.
I'm living in Corona Del Mar with Ryan at this point. And we go to Woody's. This is New Year's, correct?
Did you not live with me at the time?
No.
Okay.
I believe this is New Year's. I might be okay. wrong, but I believe this is
New
Year's.
I sure hope it wasn't New Year's, folks.
I'm 95% sure.
There, is there a photo of this?
I don't know.
It's probably too dark, but...
Well, the promo picture is from New Year's that
night.
So,
I know the story he's about to tell, folks, and go. It's fair.
So, Mike and I, we are at Woody's. Mike is a...
I'm going to make sure the lights are good. Folks, if you think I'm going to throw up, fuck you.
Okay. Again, I will call Mike out if he throws up. But anyway, so... Mike loves Woody's. I've
folks,
never been a big
fan of Woody's.
I just knocked
over Tim's drink. I'm so sorry. Tim...
It's pretty fucked up, Mike. So, I've never been a big fan of Woody's, but Mike loves it to death. It's probably his favorite bar in Newport. But anyway, so we're at Woody's, and I believe this is on New Year's Eve. And so, Mike's kind of getting at me for this LaCroix incident. He's calling her, calling the girl I was with a bigger woman.
Come back, yeah.
But on this night, if Mike's going to come at me, I'm going to come at him. Mike's with a bowling ball of a woman. She is as wide as she is tall. She is probably 5'0", maybe 5'1", and she's hustier dog. She's
okay,
probably
okay,
5 foot, 180 pounds.
I'm not gonna interrupt, but we love all women. Okay, I just try to make sure the lights are still good. I think the cameras look at that. I think we're
again,
coming
Mike
up
did
really
not
good.
Throw up.
I had to buy studio lights just to make. Anyway, go.
Yeah.
Sorry.
So Mike's with.
But
a,
do you like all women? Shapes and sizes.
I do.
Ethnicities, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Go.
Absolutely. So, like I said,
do we need a drink? We're literally like, we're so fucking.
Oh, shit, yeah. No, we got to get
going. The camera
sees
these.
Does
the camera see the beer?
Do we bring in some props?
It does,
Mike?
Okay. You know what? Can we bring the beer funnel?
Mike,
it's right there.
Mike, I am going to need to take a piss.
Well, can we do a beer funnel?
We can do a beer funnel.
Finish your story.
If I'm allowed to take a piss right after, because, oh boy, I got to open the taps right now.
But we're going to leave the camera rolling, because I don't want them to think that we just, one of us went and, can we do a funnel?
That's fine.
Can you hold the funnel for us?
Dude,
finish the story, though.
I think that's all I had to say. Mike's with a lovely woman. A fantastic woman who is as wide as she is tall, and that's okay.
I love the guess
here. Okay. So, she's probably 5 foot, maybe 5 foot one, and Jeez. She's like as wide as she is tall. And Mike is grinding, and I mean he is enjoying this more than like a hot stripper in Vegas. Like he's
with
loving
he's
like, it's New Year's. I'm about to get some ass.
It's New Year's.
I'm fired up.
Is this
right
New
now.
Year's?
I believe it was.
Jeez, folks.
So
this is well deserved.
I mean, I'm sure she was a lovely lady. I never got the...
You saw her.
I saw her. I never got the opportunity to speak to her, though.
Yeah.
But she seems like a lovely lady.
Yeah.
You seemed like you enjoyed yourself, and that's really all that matters.
Happy New Year, right?
Happy New Year.
What?
It was a great way
she was
to dial in...
She was a Latina?
2020. Yes.
Okay, but...
so... but, a TLL WAP. Okay. But not the tea.
We got a funnel here, folks.
We got a funnel.
So we're now on, get one. We're now running behind pace here. I think we got a funnel. You can hold it up for us?
I can.
Okay. This is straight from Amazon, folks. I don't know what we got to do.
I mean, we're opening this fucker up right now.
We're opening. We're run. You know, this might go 2 hours, which is fine.
Am I not going to get an intro?
So, all right. So, right here, this is buddy of mine from SC, Drew Osroe. He's a current roommate of mine.
I should go by Jalen Green.
He is from Austin, Texas.
We love Austin, Texas.
Oh, we.
Tim Dillon, the homeless problem is big.
We love Austin, Texas.
We love the homeless.
Do you love the homeless here?
More homeless.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You say more homeless, but you're from Texas. That doesn't mean shit.
Can we flash
get
a photo
all
of me?
The buses from everywhere and just send them to Austin. I approve this message.
Oh boy.
I've been to Austin, Texas, and I literally wore a horns down shirt, and we're gonna flash it because I didn't know how fucked up that was.
Did you go during the U.S.?
Yeah, I wore game? I got a custom shirt made. Yeah. I picked it up in Santa Ana of a horns down.
Oh, boy.
In SC colors.
Okay.
I should have gotten killed, right?
That's a bold move.
I should have gotten killed, right?
I mean, UT's terrible right
well,
now.
I didn't know how... That from what I learned, that means...
That's a big fuck you, like, to the city of Austin.
The burnt
so.
Orange is kind of like religion down there.
No, but what if you saw, because I walked around the campus, a Longhorn logo upside down in SC colors. That's...
So
I probably should have gotten shot.
I'm going to explain to the viewers.
I would have said, this guy hooks up with 5'1", 190-pound Dominicans.
So, for those
Stop!
At home, for
Stop,
those at home
dude.
Who don't
Stop!
Understand what's going on
There's
right now.
There's one time, dude.
USC and the University of Texas are big rivals, especially in the early 2000s.
We're building the funnel here live, folks.
There are some Rose Bowl games. Vince Young did a stupid thing that I hate to this day.
Vince Young was silly. He was silly.
Anyway, University of Texas is in Austin, and they're the Longhorns. So you go horns up. But everyone... I would say USC and OU.
I got no idea, man. This is a duel.
Are very big on the horns down. So it's horns up for Texas.
We're trying to figure out the funnel right now. Ryan, can you help us figure out this funnel right here? We're an hour in, folks, so we got 30 minutes. We got to kill one. I mean, we have to get some. This is ridiculous at this point. That's why we're dialing up the funnel.
Dude, I need to do this funnel so I can take a piss and come back.
So
because I'm going to piss my pants.
All right, folks, we're going to take a break.
Technical
we're not
going
to take a break. Just let me
No, we are going. Wait, so I'm staying.
You're going to stay. You can talk about whatever.
No. We are. Okay. Viewers, do we look like that we're about to throw up a beer? No. We're going to take an intermission. We're going to be back momentarily. I have to piss, too. Oh, are we funneling right now?
I'm funneling.
Oh, man.
At least I'm funneling. Where's this? Is there a second? There's like two tubes.
We got a lot of. This is just...
Yeah,
we got some confetti.
We did confetti.
At least
so
you
I'm
saw it.
I'm headphones off. It. Oh, boy.
Should we do another one?
All right, four.
Ready? I'll do it right now. Should I do it this way?
Oh, yeah.
And then it'll come back or what?
Yeah, it'll come back.
Do it.
Hey! Did it come back?
Oh, that was perfect.
No, did it come back?
Oh, yeah.
It did. It went out a little bit.
This wind is... fucking me up, dude. Sorry.
Anyway, so
okay, just
viewers at home, I got a nice little funnel here.
Okay. Send one back. Go.
So you got to chug your motherfucker. So.
Yeah, he was telling me I was going. It's 4:42. Oh yeah, Colby. Hey, foam is beer.
I'm gonna go take a piss.
Well, then we gotta pause. Do you? You know what, guys? We're gonna pause. We'll be right back.
Yeah, I gotta pee.
We'll be right back. We're going to pause. I'm going to finish this one. We're like an hour in. We got to pause real quick. Nobody's throwing up. We're not being a fucking pussy. But, like, we got to figure out the funnel. We got to figure out a lot of shit. We got to figure out, like, what's next. And we have a long... We're not done yet. You guys don't even know what I have in store. Kobe's out of here, but I fucking brought him a grill. He claims to be a chef. This is hilarious. You couldn't draw it up better than this. We're an hour in. We got about maybe 30, 40 left. Or however it takes. I literally bought a grill. He has no idea. I have it right up here in a bag. We're going to be grilling some steaks here, folks. Stay tuned. Let me finish this. And then, you know what? We had some shit on here about, like, the cat photo. So let's just flash the cat photo.
You're here live with me right now.
Right now. What the hell ate that? What the fuck ate that? Like, what ate that cat?
Whatever,
or what ate it? Was it like a coyote?
Right? Said an hour and a half.
Is it a shark? It's a... You'll know what I'm talking about.
But
second on the list is Halo's Moneyline. We always hit that. Flash a photo of me with the banner. We always bet on that. So our vibe in the apartment was like either win or lose Halo's, right?
But we're just here to pee.
Third was the softball league. I mean, I'll just quickly... Actually, we might want to save the softball league. We're going to save that. We're going to save the softball league. Some of these might get re... Maybe while he's growing, then we bring these back up.
When you take nine beers to the dome...
Chef Bulby Flay. At Chef Bulby Flay. Let's look this guy up on Instagram here.
So, again, I don't know what this is.
I'm getting texts right now, folks.
Yeah, it's just proof that I'm not here.
This brings me back to like the Saul episode where I just get left. Like somebody just leaves me. Crazy. Just and you know what I love is like people just show up. It's like somebody just wants. Always somebody's right here at all times. But in real chat, we'll be back. We will discuss the Halos and the softball league, and then I'm gonna right when he comes back from this, I'm just gonna bring out the fucking grill and the steaks. I have two filet mignons in the fridge, which I'm gonna go grab. So pause it right now. We'll be back.
And I, or fucking whatever. Let me just. We got some annoying ass like button flies on these.
So what do we do with the counter? That's a good question. The counter still goes. The counter still goes. So this is 8:45. We're about it still goes. So we started at 7:41. We're about an hour 4 minutes in. We have like 25 minutes. So the counter goes. You see the beers. We have to get it an hour and a half. We have. I'm gonna be honest. We started the counter at 7:40. It's 8:45. So that is. We're about an hour 5 minutes. So we have 25 minutes to kill this. So we're not drinking any of these. When we come back, we have 25 minutes to kill this. And I'm gonna cue the timer. 25 minutes. We'll see you guys in a minute.
All right, and I'm gonna bring you boys back.
And I also have to change the battery of the GoPro. Where'd this guy go?
Here we go. So this is our.
We'll see you in a minute.
Bam, bam, Bakuba, shout out to Action Bronson. And we're going back up on the roof.
All right, folks. I was about to walk off, but he's back.
I'm back. I just had to take a piss. See, we're back on set. Mike, where are you? See, we're here.
Okay, buddy. Okay. Wow. This is going to be, hey, if you're an editor, it's going to be a fun edit. So the camera's
rolling. I mean, you're your own editor, man.
No, I know. We got confetti everywhere. We have confetti everywhere. We'll show you this video after. But, okay.
All right.
Well, I just said we have 25 minutes.
Let's keep going.
I'm going to, I got to swap a battery.
Okay.
So the video has to stop.
All right, I want everyone to know that I did not throw up.
No. But
I took a selfie video the whole time.
We have to swap a battery.
Swap battery.
Of the camera.
Go do it.
Okay.
I'm going to drink more beer. Fuck.
But unfortunately, we have to swap it.
Who?
Andrew.
Who?
Andrew.
I don't know promos.
We have 20 minutes. Is it enough?
Oh, he is?
I was just talking to him on the phone, and he's in London, and he was telling me I was so fired up to go to that game because of the FPL.
What the fuck?
Dude. Okay, we got 20%. I think we could wrap it up with that, no? Is it worth a shot? All right, guys, this is Mike behind the camera. Colby, stay right there. Don't touch your beer. Don't touch it. Okay, we'll be back in 1 second. How's everybody doing? Hope you're enjoying the first 70 minutes of the episode. Nice and clear, good audio, good video, Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube. But we did get some technical difficulties, which is why you hear that beep. Or if you're watching on YouTube, you can see it on the screen. When we went to replace the GoPro battery, you might have seen Colby on the table, and then I got up to change the battery. We turned it back on, and I had no idea the GoPro had a time-lapse option, which put 50 minutes of video down to 4 minutes, which is why you're about to see it skip around. So we got the audio to sync with the video, so it actually looks not that bad. And obviously, if you're on Apple Music or Spotify, it'll sound fine. But yeah, you can definitely tell that we were about 15, 20 beers in, so we were kind of rambling. So if you don't like it, turn it off, skip through it, all good. Enjoy it, and we will see you next time, episode number 5.
So, again, Mike, are we rolling again?
We're rolling.
All right, so this
counter is getting started in 1, 2, 3. It's back.
All right, so I'm back. I took a piss break. I took a little video. We might show it.
No, we might not.
They
saw the video.
All right,
I was rolling.
All right, we'll do a little fast forward of the video, but... I took a little selfie video of me in the bathroom to make sure that to show the viewers I didn't throw up.
So did I have a drink in my hand?
This beer here is poured in here. That's
did I have a drink in my hand? Maybe, probably not. Right? I think.
So
I didn't.
We are.
So I just killed it. So we have.
So we are.
Colby, unofficially, I think we have about 24 minutes left. So look at our clock. We have until like
9:15.
Yeah, I don't know.
9:17.
I don't know. We gotta chug one now, I guess. But we have a lot to talk about. Well, you know what, guys?
Let's get back.
You know what, guys?
Let's get back on track.
What did I say when Colby left?
I don't know because I was not here.
What? We have a gift for you.
Oh boy.
I brought you.
Should I be worried?
I brought you a grill.
What do you mean?
There's a grill in my bag over here. No, can somebody bring the grill over?
There's not a grill.
May I get a grill?
Oh, thank you.
Excuse me?
Ooh. All right, yeah. I'm going to put a hoodie on, but apparently, what do you mean there's a grill?
Can I get
for
that package right there? Yeah. This podcast might go 2 hours, but who gives a fuck?
Holy shit. Oh my god.
Folks.
What the fuck is this?
Amazon delivered this thing about a couple hours ago. We have a Hamilton Beach grill because we have a lot to shit to talk about, but Colby's a chef. So I literally, this podcast might go 2 hours. I don't give a fuck. Full Joe Rogan. Can we get it going? So, I have my keys.
So I have to grill some shit for you then. Is that what you're saying?
And I brought steak.
Oh,
I brought steak.
God.
He brought you a task, a chore.
So I come on your podcast and I have to make you dinner.
He did buy you a grill, though.
I bought you a grill.
Apparently he bought me a grill.
You can keep it if you want. Up to you.
I don't know if I want this grill, but you know what?
This is fucking legend shit, folks.
So,
fuck everybody doing a podcast. Fuck all you guys. Fuck all you guys' views. Do you buy a grill on the show? I don't think so. We got to build the grill. This is going to take a minute.
All right, so I'm going to let Mike build the grill because I'm not going to build this fucking grill right now. But anyway,
can we even build it?
So Mike's going to build this grill.
Hard, right?
No.
It should be. I thought it was plug and play.
Yeah, no.
This is not a plug and play.
Oh, man.
So for those who don't know, I like cooking a lot. I'd like to consider myself an A minus quality chef.
Yeah, so you got some stickers.
I like grilling meats a lot.
What was I thinking?
Do some like side veggies and shit. But I like cooking a lot, and so apparently
give him the rundown of Bulby Flay, the chef.
So Bulby Flay, Chef Bulby Flay.
I was gonna open it up, but
it is my chef Instagram.
We're in trouble here, folks. We're in trouble.
I do not post on it nearly as much as I should.
We can make this though. I have faith. You're a mechanical guy.
I'm not building shit. I'm your guest.
I gotta build it?
Yes, I'm your guest. I'm not building shit. I'm fucked ass up. Anyway,
We're in trouble. I like cooking a lot. We're in trouble because
I've always liked cooking. Gordon Ramsay is the guy who got me into cooking. And you're like, oh, if Gordon Ramsay...
I should have had this shit. My fault. There's a grill.
If Gordon Ramsay is your idol, why are you called Chef Bulby Flay? Because it just works. Like Bobby Flay, Bulby Flay, I'm Colby.
Oh, we lost one.
Oh, so hey, yeah, Sophie Flay did go to USC. She did.
All right, dude, there's three pieces. It can't be that hard. I think if there's no screws, you just lock them in, I think.
You sure there
Well, set it up.
There's no screws. So hold
all right, so
this.
At Chef Bulby Flay, that's my Instagram.
There's no screws in there.
All right, look, wait.
I don't post on it often. But yeah.
Hey, this grill works. Oh, my God. I don't know.
But I do like cooking. I do cook for, like, family, like, Christmas and Thanksgiving. I like cooking in general.
We
got to
get the... Okay,
but
Colby.
I'm not
Colby,
making
so
this
as we try to get
grill,
this grill
no
going, as we try to get... And I need all hands on deck here.
Not me, though.
Can you tell them about the two things?
Yeah.
The grill.
Oh, we're going to...
Tell them about the softball league. And you know what?
Ooh, the softball league.
If we don't
okay.
finish, you know, fuck you guys. We okay. got Tim's drink here.
All right, so softball
oh,
league.
Fuck.
I'm going to take a drink real quick.
I spilled a dabble. Fuck you guys.
Sorry,
so softball
the grill.
League.
That piece.
So
there you go.
This is probably...
But that might. I think that slides right in.
This yeah. isn't... So,
yes, it does. It's so, Tim's so, right here. Here live. That slides right in.
All
right,
move your mic away, Mike.
We're here.
Move your mic away.
Am I yelling in your ear?
No, but I want to talk about. I want you to be able to talk to Tim about building this grill.
Well, Tim is the go to. I knew it. It just it was a plug and play, folks.
But I'm trying to talk about the softball league. So
okay,
softball
go.
League.
Go.
So all right, ladies and gentlemen.
We have about how many minutes?
Softball league. So me, Mike, this is when we're living on the peninsula, and we create. No, we don't create, but we make a team.
We have some viewers tripping us. Ridiculous. Chill out.
We make a team, and we make a.
Tim's the goat.
It's a slow pitch softball league. Okay. None of us have played softball ever, but I would say about half the team has played at least high school baseball. Some of us played like club maybe a year in college. Some of us like Fugman.
If this girl works,
Fugman was pretty good. Shout out Fugman. Like he was a better ball player on the club SC team. Like
all that Colby finished, but the grill is hot. Not yet. Tim's the goat. Shout out Tim built this grill.
Yeah.
Where's your apron? Like, this thing's got to be started up soon, right?
My apron's downstairs.
We also don't have any plugs up here, so.
We're gonna make a plug.
Oh, we do. Oh,
we have a plug. We have, sir.
We have a nice little.
We have a plug here. I'm going to take off my headphones. Tim can sit in my seat.
I'll continue talking about this softball league.
I'm going to get the grill set up, folks.
So, this softball league, everyone. This softball league, it's made up of a bunch of 23, 24-year-old guys at minimum played like pony baseball in Orange County, which for those of you who don't know, it's like there's like Little League, which brings you to like sixth grade. There's like 2 years of pony, which is like seventh and eighth grade. And then there's high school baseball.
Give Tim a welcome to Mic'd Up right here.
Yeah, everyone give Tim a warm welcome. Tim is a lovely man. And we do salute him. Anyway, so back to this team. So, like I said, most of us have played at a minimum high school baseball. Some of us play like varsity in high school. Like I went to I played varsity baseball in high school, but like my high school was like dog shit in baseball. So like I don't know if it really counts. I played club baseball for 1 year at USC. Connor Fugman, another teammate. Was a great player, but we join a softball league, and a lot of us thinking that hey, we've played baseball before. It's an adult rec league. We're just going to join the top level league. We're going to join the best of the best in Newport Beach, Costa Mesa, and we're going to have fun with it. It wasn't not fun, but we lost every fucking game. Because pitching, it's slow pitch softball. Like, we all play baseball, but for those who don't know, softball is a completely different sport, and mainly because of the pitching.
The slow pitch is hard.
It's a difficult transition. The grill's on. Do we have... Wait, all right, Mike, you have this grill set up. Sorry, I'm going to continue about this the softball team, but... What am I grilling for you, Mike? Like, you're like, hey,
Fox,
I have this grill for you.
This is undisputed the best Mic'd Up podcast ever filmed. I bought some filet mignon.
No, you didn't.
And it's coming in hot, and we're like an hour 20 in, but who gives a fuck? Who gives a fuck if we finish this shit?
This is a longer dog.
I don't give a fuck. We always knew it was going to be, and sorry that you guys are like.
I told you, Mike. You can tap me in. I'm your tag team partner.
I don't want to wave the white flag, but when it's done. When we have to wave the white flag, then we'll jointly finish it.
The Roomba.
All right. Well.
All right. So.
So the grill's heating up. Tim built this. There's no way in fuck that I fucking could have. Max.
You did break it.
Well, do we even need a top? You might, eventually.
So
heat. I'm gonna turn up to the sear settings. So you finish your story. I'm gonna get the meats.
All right.
And then.
So back to softball. So we. As a team, we're like, we need a team sponsor. Like, every other team in the league has a sponsor.
We have how many left?
And we're trying to figure it out.
We have 11 left.
So, thankfully, one of our teammates, him and his dad own a fantastic pizza joint. And unfortunately, at this time, it is no longer owned by them, and it's gone to dog shit since. But Johnny's Pizza. We salute Johnny's Pizza, the UNSC family. We're part of a fantastic pizza joint called Johnny's Pizza. And the Andolini Pizza, it's this sausage. It's a meat lover's pizza. And no joke, it's some of the best out there. But anyway, the Johnny's Pizza team were the quote-unquote sponsors of our softball team. So we joined this league, and like I said, we joined the top division. We're like, you know what? Like, all of us played at least high school ball. Some of us were actually pretty good. And we're going on about this team, and we joined this league, and we win zero fucking games.
Like, zero.
Like, it's not like, oh, we came close. We won zero games, and we weren't even close on them.
Yeah, you're getting pretty smashed.
Yeah, so, and the issue is, and I didn't know this with softball at the time, the bat makes all the difference. So, so we had, I don't know, 10, 12, 15 guys. I forget exactly how many guys we had on our team. We're like, we're all going to pitch on, like, a $100 bat. You know, it's going to be 10 bucks a head, and we'll have a bat. Turns out there's like $600-$700 bats for fucking softball, and it got to the point where, you know, we had this $100 bat because we don't want to spend a whole lot of money on a bat. But it got to the point where towards the end of the season, where like the league leading team, you know, we'd be the first game of the night and they'd be the second game of the night. They're like, you know what, you need to beat this team. We're gonna lend you our $600 bats. So that
just
you,
so you could play better.
Yeah, exactly. So you can actually fucking hit the ball, you know, more than 100
Folks,
feet.
We got the filet mignon here.
Oh,
Tim, you can stay on there.
Some filet Colby, dogs.
You know what? The beer challenge. We have about another 10 minutes, 20.
I mean, I'll go after.
You got tap in, baby.
Do we tap in, Tim? Oh, are we waving the red flag yet? I mean, I want to see
I'm
how many.
Not.
I want to see
not.
How many that we can get done.
I'm trying to tell the story about our softball team.
Okay, but you got to get the grill. The grill's ready to go.
Is the grill hot?
We got to swap seats.
If the grill is hot, I'll get seats. After it. If the grill's not hot, then there's no fucking point yet. Anyway,
hey guys,
so.
Tim's the goat.
So we joined this team. We're
swap,
shit.
Swap, bro. This is not
apparently
your side.
I'm swapping.
This is not your side. This is not your side, dude. Okay. All right, we're swapping here, folks.
Love it.
All right. Thank you, Tim. The goat. Maybe you'll make a new appearance. Is it hot?
It's warm.
Okay, it's warm. Oh, my. I'm back, folks. It's been a minute. This is my drink?
No, that's my fucking drink.
So we got a... What's our actual counter?
I don't know. You're behind me, though. That's all I
Fuck,
know.
Man.
This is like number 9 or 10 for me. I can't
Are
remember.
You going to grill us these steaks? But I'll tell you one thing.
Close to the top. Yeah, it doesn't. I mean, it's not.
Tim, could you get us the? Can you get us the spray from downstairs?
You need the spray.
I mean, otherwise these steaks are gonna stick.
Get in the apron.
So, no, we don't need an apron. So, all right, we had a joke called full apron. But
hold on, folks. One thing. I'm really not that fucked up, but
yeah, you are.
We're at a party. We got the filet mignon here, but I went to Memphis, Tennessee. And I literally went to Rendezvous Barbecue. I brought you fillets.
Some fillets.
And I brought you one seasoning. It's all
so season
it needs.
These dogs. Season the dogs.
Yeah, but this is all it needs. This is for you, the chef.
Good. I'll
I brought you a grill on the show, dude. Who the fuck does that?
You
Who the fuck
open
does
this
that?
Up.
This is done.
Yeah, that's.
I don't know about the counter, folks. We might fall short. And then we'll tap in the boys, but...
Here's the thing.
We're talking, dude. We're not boozing. The chef's got to get to work here.
Yeah, apparently.
Who brings a chef a grill
I was
and
not
meat
aware.
On the show?
I was
Can
not
Can you show
aware.
The viewers the meat that you're doing right now?
So we got some filet dogs here. We got some Rendezvous famous seasoning here.
So Colby, folks.
So we got some steak dogs here. We're waiting on some spray from... I fucked your
You'll need
laptop.
The over-the-top view.
What?
You'll need the over-the-top view.
I know, but show the camera the view. The camera can fucking pick it up I higher. Mean,
these are some great filet dogs right here. We got some fantastic Rendezvous.
Shout out Rendezvous Memphis. Great barbecue.
Yeah, Mike's talking these guys up. So shout out Rendezvous.
I've been there.
Barbecue.
I've ate their grease.
It's not yet. It's a better dog.
I'm getting offered a cigar yet, but it's not yet.
It is not time.
It's not time yet. We're not shutting down yet. Oh, we got Tim coming back.
Tim is back.
Is Tim bringing us some booze?
We got some good spray.
Got some pepper. obviously.
Okay, good, 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 right, good.
A little bit, even though they're a little seasoned.
Okay.
Some nice quality flake salt. There.
Flake salt.
The shit. Hey,
which is much better than regular salt.
Where is his apron?
I don't know.
Where fucking apron.
Where is it? No, I need the apron. Where is it?
I've never seen Ryan, an apron.
Where's the apron? Okay. Let the chef do his work here, folks. So Colby, where do I got to pick up where you left off?
Oh, no. The spray is done. The spray is...
Tim's a legend.
Ant.
Okay.
Nothing. It's fucking dead.
I'm really not that hammered, I'll tell you, folks.
Tim, can you just get me some oil and some, like...
If this grill
towels.
Works...
Or a spray. A spray works.
If this grill works...
If we have another spray that works. Or just give me oil and paper towels.
Colby, just tell me where you left off on the softball story.
So we were...
Tell me where you left off.
We were dog shit and we won zero games, but okay.
We won...
No, folks. We won zero games the first season. Zero.
Folks, he doesn't remember. We won one game.
Not the first season.
We celebrated at Island. There was only one season, brother.
No, there was two seasons. We dropped below.
Ryan, up here now. I need to get Ryan in here. Ryan, we won one game that first season, and we went to Islands, and we celebrated. I'll play the video right now. 1, 2, 3, play it. We literally won one game.
I'm not sure if that was the first or the second season.
That was one game.
Because we did two seasons, and we went one division lower.
No, we never did that.
Yes, we fucking did.
No, maybe I wasn't invited on the team then.
No, you were.
We didn't play two seasons, dude.
Well, we didn't finish the second season.
Oh, we quit.
We did quit mid-season.
But I'm talking about the first season.
I don't know if we won.
So we were talking about the first season that... I don't know what he's told you guys. I've been trying to get the fucking grill going and the steaks. We probably have, but we started at 7:40. We're done. We expired.
I mean, we're an hour and a half in, and unfortunately...
Finish this, then. We got to be honest. We probably have, like, 30 seconds. I'll finish it. We left... oh, man. We left 9 out there.
You know what?
We left 9 out there, folks. I mean, we did 20.
A fucking valiant effort. Hour and a half. 15 was a tall... It was a tall order.
But we were talking and, like, trying to get a grill going. I'll finish this.
We did
folks.
Get distracted.
Tim.
A lot of excuses.
Tim, you're tapped in now.
I'm just hearing a lot of excuses.
You're tapped in. After I finish this. Because we've killed. We have 9 left. Hold on. Let me just... I'm going to finish this, and then we're going to wave the white flag.
What flag are you waving, Mike? We are not done. We have so much shit to do still.
Tim's tapped in.
Whoops, fuck that up. That's okay.
We finished 20, folks. The final counter, 20.
Yep.
20. Hey, Ryan, can you throw me my water?
I don't think there's that much left.
Flip the grill.
Honestly.
Oh, fuck. I need more beer. All right, we got the grills on. We got the steaks are on the grill.
Hey, put the top down.
Oh, man, I threw up.
What was that?
I threw up. Just liquid.
All right, let it be known, I'm at 0.
It was liquid, man. That's alive.
I'm at 0. Mike's at 2. I have had more beers.
That was liquid, but let it be known.
I mean, it's beer.
Yeah, it's beer. I apologize.
I don't give a shit about the throw up.
We're going to count that.
This is number, like, 11 for
me,
more
so, like, it's a beer challenge, and it's all liquid, so that means it was all beer.
Yeah. So I'm going to do... Our final count is 19 and a half. Done.
8 more.
Wait. What's up, guys? Ooh, I do love Tyreek. Okay.
Can we flip the grill for the viewers? Because they can see the steak.
Oh. Well, yeah. After he savages it. You didn't throw up in the cup?
No, the liquid just came out.
And you don't have COVID?
No, sir.
Cool. So I'm just going to use your cup then as your tap-in
partner to finish. I'm now back in. But you know what? We've already established, as long as the beer is down, it counts. So we finished with 20.
I need to pee again.
Stop.
No, you don't.
We literally have 20 more minutes. You don't leave your steaks.
By the time I come to piss again.
All right, go piss.
When I come, when I come
so
back.
So do you know what we're gonna close on?
Let me tap in, Mike.
Yeah, Tim.
Fuck this
guy. Tap in, Tim.
Fuck this guy.
You know, I feel good. I threw up a fucking Coors Light. Is that? Tim, can we twist the grill around?
Yeah.
Tim is the grill expert. Hold on. I can help you guys. You guys got to see these beautiful steaks.
Oh. There went the top again. Not the highest quality grill.
I know, but it
works. There you go. They can see that.
They can see that, right? Yeah.
Oh my god, I think
we're good, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you're fine.
Does that freeze up?
I mean, it's not on this side.
Can you get it on?
So, yeah.
Is that it's not down?
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's just not, you know, Chinese standards these days just are.
All right, so you know what, guys?
You know, not great.
We officially waved the white flag. We did not finish. We finished 20. I'm going to count the last one.
Here's
but Tim,
two for Mike.
I appreciate it, Tim. You know, the episode gets better when you just bring in unexpected guys. Oh, Tim. You should have been Tim and I, dude. Or Tim and Colby.
Going on number three for Mike.
Dude, Tim, if you can, I'm going to take one, too. I mean, we just got to finish these. That's all I care about. Just finish them, right? Ryan, finish them on camera. No? We are now waving the white flag. We finished 20.
Honestly, I don't know where I am. I'm just here for the free beer.
All right, well, I'm going to finish the softball story. So we would play softball, Tim. And
I've heard stories.
And we would go to the venue, and I was off work, and I would show up. It was the Johnny's Pizza team. I don't know what Colby has told you. Tim is just chugging right now. We got a helicopter in the air. I don't know if you guys can hear it. Oh, man. Okay, well, we'd show up, and there's just wives, daughters, dogs of the opposing team that were playing that would come up to view. They would come up to view the game. And
yeah,
we never had anybody there.
Yeah.
But we always lost.
Well,
we won
yeah,
one time.
You weren't very good.
We won one time. And that was
and
it.
You had a shitty bat. So.
So I would go to work and they'd say, Mike, did you guys win today? And they would, as we discussed, your event company, and they would say, did you win? They were all hyped up about the game. And I'd say, did you win this week? And every week was a loss.
Huh.
But I'll be honest, I love baseball. I bet it every day. I used to play it. I was a top five player on that team. I'm not even, like, statistically, yes. Which I'm shocked by.
Top five player on the worst team is.
I know.
Like, you
know, I know.
Like,
you're
dude,
right. You're right.
I'm sorry for trolling.
You're right.
You at
you're
the
right,
moment.
Tim.
It,
you're,
your
you're,
whole team was bad. Though.
Tim, you're keeping me in check today. You're keeping me in check, dude.
I mean, I'm keeping you in check with the beers. I'm keeping you in check in
fuck,
your softball.
Dude.
You know.
Crazy. Thank you, Tim. You're right.
Excuse
you're,
me.
Nothing to brag about. So we literally have one more thing to talk about as Colby girls, or we have a couple more, but. Colby and I played in the match, and were you aware of that? You're one of Colby's good buddies. You heard about the match, the golf match for $1,000.
Yeah, I definitely did. Yeah. So Colby, just for background on you,
he's back.
I did not throw up. Let it be known.
Okay. We're past that point. We waved the white flag at 20. It's done.
I almost did.
Colby's a couple years younger than me.
Yeah.
Just FYI for the crowd here. And
you're blocking the light, brother. Get the fuck out of the light.
I'm trying to flip these.
The mic's going hot, though. By the way, if you're listening to this on Apple Music or Spotify, you're missing out, right? Tell them they're missing out.
Oh, you're missing out.
Turn on YouTube, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Turn on Utah.
Yeah.
YouTube. Utah.
Utah.
Jeez.
Go Utes.
Oh, man.
No, but Colby's a couple years younger than me, just... For your reference,
yeah,
and he was one of my pledges. That's
yeah.
how I know. That's how I know him. That's how I know Ryan
yeah.
Cargyle.
Yeah, but we're gonna keep it PG here. Like,
oh yeah, no, definitely.
They were good guys, right?
I mean, I live with
the
them
chef
right
is
now.
Worried, folks. He's trying to. If he can deliver, it. You would agree. If you can If you could unbox a grill and grill two filet mignons, that's a win.
If you could successfully unbox a grill and set it up and grill two filet mignons.
It's crazy. Like, this is like crazy shit. And
hey, Colby.
Folks.
By the way, sorry.
This episode is unreal. Folks, episode is unreal.
Yeah, I apologize. But bringing Colby back in here. But
are you swapping out?
No.
You kind of.
No, I'm bringing him into the story here.
This episode is crazy, folks.
I definitely just downed three beers on behalf of this guy. So
me too.
You're
I'm soft, dude. I can't. No.
Mike's lacking.
No. I said I just downed three beers on Mike's behalf.
Thank you. On my behalf.
So you're behind, actually.
You know what? We got to finish this. I'm calling in the reinforcements. Come on. I mean, we have to call him in.
We have more to talk about. No. Sorry, Tim.
Tim's going
to
do it?
I'm taking over.
No, absolutely.
Tim can hang out, though.
We need to finish this up.
We have to finish this up.
Absolutely take over.
But you can see, you can.
Oh.
The viewers love you, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
The viewers love Tim.
Okay, so.
Maybe we bring Tim on in the future.
Mike, bring us back on track here.
Are your steaks good? Okay, we're going to bring you guys back. So.
Here's the thing. I have no
fucking
idea.
I'm actually sobering up, if I'm being honest with you guys. I'm sobering up.
No, you're not.
I am sobering up.
You're fucking not.
The steaks are looking good.
The steaks are looking kind of nice. I'm not going to lie.
Four.
Yeah, but. Four left?
You
got to
go kill all those. What do you mean? You get him out of here. No. You two kill those four.
Give me two.
Well, I did take a piss.
We got guys blocking fucking lights and shit.
Hey, Tim, Ryan, fucking audience, can we get like a plate to put these fuckers
on?
Yeah,
give me a plate and like a knife.
Yo, when are you fuckers?
Let's turn this dog off.
And or Drew.
I can't believe I'm still blown away that we grilled fucking two steaks on this grill that Tim built. Tim's the goat of the night. Thank you so much for the plate. I can't believe it.
We need some knives to cut these steaks.
Jeez. It's just crazy that it's fucking actually grilled.
You gotta eat it with your bare hands, dude.
Okay. No. We're not doing that tonight. We're not doing that tonight, chef. You're a chef. I want to knife it up.
Show them the inside, dude.
I wanted to try it.
May I get like a knife and fork, dude? Like honestly. Yeah.
It's some good medium rare, motherfuckers.
I want
the credit on your podcast here for pulling those.
Then get back here. Then get back in the camera.
No, for pulling those.
They can't see that, dude. They can't see that. You're blocking the camera. Get back here. Get back here. No, eat it right here.
Drew, give me that steak,
dude. You're blocking the camera. Oh, man. I mean, okay. Let me try it out here, folks. I anticipated a knife and fork, but we're going to... You know what? How... Oh, shit. This is...
No, it's just foam, and I'm not trying to drink fucking foam.
Did you?
No.
You did.
I spit foam. I didn't throw up, Tim.
I mean, beer is foam.
Tim, I'm not an 18-year-old pledge anymore.
Bro, that's good meat.
Yeah, it's a good fucking steak. Yes. And now you're eating my fucking... This is my steak. Goddamn.
Honestly...
I can't believe it, folks.
I want to say, Mike, that this is more of my steak than Colby's.
I mean, I cooked it, so like...
You put it on...
That's like saying Mr. Grill Factory Man.
I just took it off at the perfect time right now.
I mean, I did take it off.
So Colby.
I took it off. So
Colby. Colby, Tim, can we wrap it up real quick?
Yeah.
So Colby, I'll be honest with you. That was a good steak. We have to bring this home because my first guest, Saul, couldn't bring it home. I hate to call him out. We have to bring it home. Gotta bring it home. We have about 10 minutes. We'll wrap this shit up.
All right.
I literally think this is the best podcast I've ever made in my life.
I fucking hope it is.
I literally think Tim was a goat. The fact that we grilled two steaks, we're not done with that one. We probably need that steak.
Eat your fucking steak, Mike. I ate everything.
I thought that we would
like
get some knives
bites.
And shit.
Fucking knives.
Yeah,
Mike,
absolutely.
Mike, fuck your knives. Eat your goddamn steak.
You're not about to hit the steak. Like,
I'm not gonna eat it with my hands, dog. I'm not.
Dude,
I'm not, dude.
Do
Mike,
I'm not.
Mike, you coward.
I'm not like a fucking barbarian.
Mike,
dude. I'm not a barbarian.
Mike, get your fucking
eat
inner,
your
look at,
Mike.
Look,
yes,
Mike.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
It's a steak.
It's a fucking.
By the way,
piece of meat.
I can't
eat
believe,
it.
Bro. That shit showed up at my house at fucking 6:30, and it worked.
For the viewers at home.
You have no idea.
The viewers at home did not know this, but Mike was supposed to arrive to my place at 5:45, and he's waiting on.
I was waiting for some reason. You didn't know why.
Mike's like, hey, like, I can't come. I'm going to be late. I'm just like, Mike, we knew about this for like 2 weeks or so.
Yeah, we planned big time.
I'm like, why are you so late? And he's like, I'm waiting for something. And it is the steak.
I appreciate it.
Mike, what time did the steak show up?
It showed up at like, Amazon dropped it off at like 6:15.
Yeah, he was supposed to be at my place at 5:45. And he lives like 25 minutes away or something.
But one thing, do you like the rendezvous? It's good.
You the seasoning?
It's all you need.
Oh, seasoning is fantastic.
When
it's, You know what? Listeners. Listeners.
Because that's all you need.
We have a Charlie Virgo's Rendezvous Famous Seasoning.
I've been to Memphis. I've done it. That's all you need.
It's a better dog.
No. When I taste this, I taste Memphis.
It's a better dog.
Is it not a good seasoning?
It is.
By the way, guys, I'm a classier guy. I'm a classier guy, but.
Mike, I ate a whole filet with my hands. Like, eat your goddamn
steak. I didn't expect we were going to have to do this, but we have to.
Well, none of us expected this, so.
We also didn't expect you to throw up on the first beer, but we're rolling with the punches.
Nor did we expect you to bring a grill to the podcast.
Nobody knew that.
Yeah, there's a lot of surprises thrown my way.
How could we have proper cutlery when we didn't even know there was
a grill coming?
Thank you. Thank you, Tim. Thank you.
The fact that we could get a grill working and grill a steak is a success.
Boom.
All right, Mike, can you get us back on track here? Because we got a few more things we do want to talk about before we wrap shit up.
Yeah, we you know what? Tim, Legend, Colby, let's wrap this up. This is going
to
be one of the best episodes ever, I think. This is going to be like huge shit. I have a note in here. Mike pulls out grill on the side that when he left.
I did not see this before.
He did not see this. Colby begins to grill, share cooking tips, and then it says, "Ask about the eviction." We've already went through that.
We've kind of gone through the eviction.
And then we have three more bullets left.
No,
Ryan coming in.
There's 1 point. So
hold on.
No, we were throw.
We have the fitness.
I want to talk.
Do you have anything to say about the fitness journey of 2 minutes? And guess what? Just like
I already talked about fitness. It's find
That's
your maintenance
okay.
calories.
Okay.
Eat in a deficit.
So the one thing that we want to talk about, and then I don't give a fuck, is like the match. This is it. This is the
the match.
This
we
is
have
the,
to talk
this
about
is
the match.
Closing shit. This is it.
Okay.
This is it. We're done. And then this is done. This is it. Right. I mean, the steak's good.
We have to talk about the match. Absolutely. So Mike, was that the match two?
Two.
So, Mike, a few months prior, did a match with our friend Connor.
Yeah.
So it is a $1,000 wager on a golf round between, you know, one person and the other person, and the winner gets $1,000 from the loser. So, Mike did his first one with Connor at what course did you do it with? Oh my God, the beers are done. Who drank the beers? I feel like there
are four.
We do have a beer here. So I have this. I have fucking beer to finish.
Mm.
Anyway, so Mike does his first quote-unquote the match with Connor Fugman, a longtime listener and a great friend of the
Connor,
pod.
Connor Fugman, we're going to bring this episode home because I'm literally, you saw me earlier, like, you know, Colby, I think this is a legendary episode. I loved the people coming in and out.
Oh, yeah.
It was so much fun.
I think it was good. I think it was
good. Like, people came in, our friends.
All right. Back to the match. Back to the match.
But the steak is good. If you can do that on that grill, I respect it. Like, I brought you on there just for the fuck of it. Yeah. Like I brought the meat. I brought the grill. I'm such a fucking idiot that I didn't have the grill already built, but it was raw. Like, the viewers saw that.
It was raw. The viewers saw the grill.
They saw it all happen. And literally...
I did not notice a grill was coming my way today.
No. I mean, but this is why this episode is going to go viral.
I hope it does.
Like, it's going to go viral. I'm not even lying to you.
It's a good...
Like, we were mixing out... The lights are crazy because it's so dark in Newport Beach right now.
It is dark.
It's dark as fuck right now.
It is a blacker night.
And the women are out tonight.
Hopefully.
So we got... Well, they're out. They're texting me.
All right. Back to the match.
Because the match... Go.
So the match, like I said...
Tell them how it started. How did they get initiated?
So Mike and our friend, longtime viewer, Connor Fugman, had a match, a $1,000 wager, and Mike lost. And
I lost the first one, yeah.
And so Mike is looking for redemption. And at this point, I lived with Mike, and... I'm like, you know what? I want to take on Mike, and unfortunately, we did not do the press that was deserved.
No, we didn't. So we're gonna plug. It's now at the match 5, right? Are we on 5?
We've done.
What's the match on right now?
4 have been done.
My phone over here.
4 has been done, and 5 has not yet been planned.
So 5 is not planned yet.
But
folks,
let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen. A rematch between me and Mike is in the works.
It's got to happen, folks. So
it's in the works. So,
I don't want to interrupt you, but may interrupt, and then I'll bring it home.
Yeah,
so on Monday morning, like you said, I lost the first match.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you know what? I'm not a golfer. You're not a good golfer, but
like,
people
you know what, Mike? We're decent. I mean,
we're okay golfers.
Like, we're like right now, like at the time, I was probably like a 15 or a 16 handicap, and I'm a low 13 right now. I've never gotten it in the 12s, I'm decent.
Colby, we have to
break a 90 is good.
We have to call him, like, tell him the real story.
Yeah,
I wake up on like a Monday and like you just chirp me.
I chirp Mike a lot,
and I'm like, you know what, Colby? No disrespect to Colby, I'm like, Colby, I will play you this Saturday at your course for $1,000.
So when he says this course, he means
my caddy needs to come up here. Caddy.
So
my caddy.
My dad is a member at Santa Ana Country Club. It's a phenomenal
I've never played
course.
It.
That's a lie.
Sure.
That's a lie because
sure.
I brought you out to Santa Ana before.
My God,
this is not
never.
A course.
A 12?
Never. Okay, this folks, if you've been
Are
listening this long,
about a 7 over
this is the last. This is it.
This is it.
Right here.
Oh my God.
So. The match, we did not do the pre-match press that this showdown deserved, unfortunately. When Mike did it the first time, there was like a 3-week match press.
Who are we
they're
DMing
talking,
right now? We're sliding
they
into
are,
DMs.
Yeah,
so now it's the match 4, okay?
So they're posting, you know, videos of them at the range.
We'll throw it up.
At them putting, at them practicing, blah, blah, blah. But when
What's
me and Mike
saying?
Went at it, because when we lived together, it'd get
He's
a little bit
down
heated between
soon,
the two.
Isn't he?
It'd get, you know,
like
heated
next
between
weekend,
the two
Willick?
Of us.
I don't know.
Like you're
so,
going 38
finish it off.
On the front.
So Mike and I, we're like, you know what? Fuck it. Let's settle the beef, because we're chirping each other, because we live with each other, and that's what happens when you live with people. You chirp, you get in.
Ryan is left, but he was my caddy.
So, yeah, Ryan was Mike's caddy. Don Franchise, the other roommate who has been... unseen, unfortunately, was my caddy.
Yeah.
After 14 holes, I'm up 2 strokes on Mike.
So Colby was, so just to give the viewers what, literally, I'm trying to drink one. We have this beer and then one more.
Cheers.
And then
cheers.
We're done, and then we jointly finish a 30. So this is one rare. And we have one more.
Yeah.
For each. Yeah. Team helped out. I don't know. We already didn't do it, but it's fine. We already knew we wouldn't. This podcast, folks, I always knew.
It's absurd.
It'd be really the most legend ever, and this rivals, like, Joe Rogan flagrant.
I would say so.
It rivals everybody.
Let's get back
Tim
to
Tim is back.
Let's get back to
Tim
match.
Is back. We love Tim.
Mike.
My phone,
okay,
baby.
Thank you, Tim.
Mike, let's get back to the match.
We're wrapping it up, because I got girls texting me to go to Wild Goose.
No, you don't.
You want to bet?
Yeah.
You want to bet?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, Mike, I don't
get
it.
All right. No, I want to look at this shit. Look at this shit, bro.
You know what? Mike does have some text. I'll give him that.
Got to go there, folks. You know how it goes.
Anyway, Mike,
wrap it
off. Finish it off.
No, I will. I will.
Yeah,
so Monday morning, I wake up. I'm like, Colby, let's play for $1,000. And he's a legendary guy. He said yes.
Yeah, $1,000.
He said, let's do it.
Cash bet.
And I said, Colby, your course, $1,000. I never played there. I swear to God.
No, you.
I swear to God.
Mike, that's
no,
a lie.
I swear to God.
Mike, I brought you to that course beforehand.
I swear to God.
Viewers, let it be known.
I swear to God,
I have
never
brought Mike to
when,
that course.
When?
Minimum twice.
Folks.
Mike is a liar.
I never played there.
Your podcast host is a liar.
Okay.
It be known.
Folks, I never played there. I swear to you.
He played
I
there
show
minimum
up.
Twice with me.
Okay. All good. You can believe it if you want. It's all good. Just be in salt.
There's no beef between us.
I showed up, 1,000 match two. You've seen the Instagram.
We both show up with 1,000 cash.
But we have like a
like
cue the video of me pulling 1,000 out from Wells Fargo right now, because I did.
Bam.
I pulled it out.
It's right here.
It was no joke. It
wasn't.
It was no joke.
Sounds good.
Oh my God. Oh yeah, that'd be great. No, come out here. You gotta come up with the lights. Oh my gosh.
Apparently we have
this is a sign to go to Wild Goose. This is I'll have a couple.
It is becoming a shit show.
We have to wrap this. Colby, we have to wrap this.
Some cheese or six.
We have to wrap this, brother.
Yeah.
So I go to the match too. Cause we always knew this was gonna run over. It's about to be 2 hours at 9.
We got 10 more minutes.
We got 10 more minutes in. I knew this is the best podcast ever.
Oh.
I show up to Santa Ana Country Club. He wants to claim I played there. I've never played there.
He has.
I've never played there. I don't lie about this type of shit.
He has.
I never played there.
He has.
And I show up. It's a business trip. Let's get this money. You already know.
All right, gentlemen. Thank you guys both for coming out here. I think this is going to be a great match today. Before we begin, everybody knows the rules of golf. We're playing strictly adhering to those rules. No pickups, no free drops, putt everything out. And yeah, shake hands, guys. Whoever loses, they don't buy a drink tonight. It's still a full send.
$1,000.
That one?
Can we show them the money?
Yeah, bring out the money.
We got the Wells Fargo.
I think the public is 80% on Mike Feehan. About 20% on Bock.
Go ahead and open this up a little bit because I'm going to be putting it back in my bank account later tonight. But here's $1,000. We got a big match, boys. Let's go. Let's tee off. Thanks for tuning in.
Let's go. Thank you.
All right.
Update from Team Mike. Through 9 holes, we're battling out here. It's all square. It is all square, even. It's a tie after 9. We got a big 9 holes to play. Thanks for tuning in. I thought I lost on hole 14. I was down how many strokes?
I'm up 2 strokes.
Two strokes with 15, 16, with 4 to play.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I'm shaking in my boots. Mm-hmm. This is done, folks. Ryan, you saw earlier, was my caddy. He was about to leave me. I was like fucked up in the head. Like I was like, I lost mentally. Colby on hole 15.
15, yeah.
Puts it water.
In the water, off the
and then
feet,
you go,
the water.
And then you go water bunker.
So, on this,
you'll never forget it because you lost the money.
Hold this. So, I'll lay it out. 15 at the course we're playing at. Water on the right. Bunker, like, kind of just goes along the water. So
yeah.
If you even go in the water, which is a hazard, your quote unquote drop is in the sand.
Hey, he sucks.
Come out here then. Come back in this shit then.
So.
He's gone, but yes.
My tee shot is in the water.
I'm holding pizza, dude.
So I take a drop in the sand.
Yeah.
My sand shot goes back in the water again. It's more of the story, it was one
of the biggest collapses I've ever witnessed. And
I put a 12 up on a par 5,
12.
A 7 over. Thankfully, Mike only put up a triple bogey.
So I was 8?
Yeah, so anyway.
So that was a 7 stroke.
So
you were up 2?
I was up 2 after 14. After 15, I'm down 2.
It's done. With 2 to play?
It's just bad.
2 to play.
3 to play, I'm down
so
2.
Well, the match is over. I came out on top by 4 strokes. Colby fought extremely hard. He hosted the tournament at his home course, Santa Ana. I want to say thank you. He's a great competitor, and on to the next one. Thanks for tuning in.
I'm here with the winner, Mike Feehan. What do you have to say?
I had to rebound from Connor Fugman somehow. Colby was absolutely a tough competitor. I don't know if you guys know, but he was up through 15 holes.
Yeah.
I was down two or three shots with three or four to play. I battled, came back, and I want to say, Ryan Cargill, thank you for the...
We salute, like, I'm holding the pizza, but if
I ended up down one.
If you're two, I know. If you're two up with two to play, you play it differently. And
you
people
do.
Talk about,
you
like,
play it safe.
People talk about, like, the PGA Tour guys, like, it's a lot of, like, fucking
it is
strategy. Because well, I knew I was up two, so I could fucking three putt.
The thing is, Mike, like, a lot of the viewers won't realize when you have a G on the line.
I know, they don't understand.
It's
dude.
Fucking,
put that on the ground.
It's fucking different. It
when
really
you have a when you
different.
Have a grand on the line, and all the guys that have came in as cameos, we love they were. I think they made the episode.
A grand's like a week's pay.
You got one left.
A grand is a week's pay these days. Like, you can't be fucking around.
Grand's a lot of money.
So
a lot of money.
So unfortunately, I wasn't able to pull it back.
And we're gonna play right now. We're gonna play. My intro video, we're going to play me paying Ryan Cargill, and then that's it. I mean, I'm sorry. Like, I've lost a lot of matches in my day. I've lost a lot of my day.
I'm 0 for 1.
Well, I love to do it again.
I think it will happen.
In the fall, we if we're running back, I think it'll be great.
Yeah, I think it will.
But, like, it that just, like I told you guys earlier, you have to keep on.
Keeping on.
Keep on, yeah, because you're never out of it.
No, you never
I
are.
Bet on a lot of PGA Tour players that they're like down three strokes with three to play and they win. You, Hideki and shit.
So you love Hideki, you love
Bryson. Am I a golf betting goat?
Yes,
I'm pretty
and
good.
No.
I'm
yes
pretty good.
No. If Tiger Masters didn't hit, I would say no. But Tiger Masters
yeah,
did fucking 5K, hit.
5K, folks.
Big 5K win for Mike.
I think it's the biggest high ever.
That's the biggest win you've had, right?
Biggest win ever. 5K, one fucking night. That's how it goes. But
that's how sports betting is. Though.
My computer here went to sleep. And we, you know what, guys? We had a crazy episode. If you guys watched all the way through.
This was a good one.
I mean, this one was unreal. The cameos that we had was so fucking great.
Oh, yeah.
We had Tim building the grill. We had Ryan with other comments. I would have to say this one is hard to top.
I hope it is.
Because we're bringing it home. Well, you grilled steak here. I can't eat this.
We grilled some filet mignon.
The
like,
fact
we,
that
we grilled filet mignon for the
first
time.
On the fucking portable grill from Amazon.
On a grill I've never touched before. And Mike,
it's good.
How was the steak?
I loved it. I mean,
it was some would say a perfect medium
dude,
rare.
I was freaking out so bad that like I brought the grill and I don't know how to build. I'm not a builder. I just raise rent.
Also, can we talk about how. If you don't eat your steaks medium rare, like, please.
We ate one steak, we shared one, and
like,
we're all good.
No, but
I don't want to waste meat, but.
No, if you like your steaks, like, well done or some shit, like, please get out of my life.
But, folks, this was a crazy episode. We're going to kill the beer. I mean, unbelievable. I think it's going to break 20K views. What do
you
think?
I hope so. Maybe 30.
I mean,
30.
We are going to send this back, and
so,
honestly.
Mike. I think the only way to properly end
this episode. Do you have any closing statements?
My closing statements are: I love America, I love Mike Feehan, and I love Coors Light.
There you go. Let's close it out. Oh,
no.
We have one song that you want to play. We can't play it, but what's your song?
Oh,
you told me it on a couple days ago.
Oh, Fortunate Son, Creedence Clearwater Revival.
We're gonna play that right now. Go.
Boom. Knee
and
chug,
it's playing right
chug,
now.
Knee chug.
Because this is a great song. You know, last episode we're gonna chug this and we're done. We actually finished it with some help.
We did. It did take. A
oh, bit. I gotta. I'm gonna be honest here, folks. This is the last beer I saw.
All I know is I'm
gonna talk it up. We finished the 30 rack with some help, but you know what? We were talking. We killed 20 in at time frame. We, and then there's just two more. I'm going to take off my headphones. We're going to chug this. I'm going to chug.
All right. Chug.
Well, they can't see it.
No, they can. So, for those who don't know,
the
MF Me Chug is like.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
That's a wrap. Mic'd up, episode 4.
Mic'd up.
We'll see you guys later. Done.
You.
Wild Goose.
For tuning in to the Mic'd Up Podcast. Be sure to tune in again for the next episode on Apple Music, Spotify, or YouTube. See you next time.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.